0-2 pitch to Ramirez. Straight away center field. Cruz going back. Still going back. And it's off the fence. Pitch right back at Hawkins, and he'll throw to first. He threw it away. And he struck him out. Dempster. Patterson strikes out again. 2-2. Struck him out looking. There it is. We are live at Minute Maid Park in Houston, the final day of the 2005 season, as WGN Sports presents Changing the Cubs. As we look back at what turned out to be a disappointing 2005 for the Cubs, we also look ahead to 2006. Still don't know what I will. And welcome to Houston. I'm Len Casper. Bob Brenly will join me here in a few minutes. This is a huge game for the Houston Astros today. Their magic number to clinch the wild card is down to one. So if they win, they are in. If they lose and the Phillies win, there will be a one-game playoff tomorrow afternoon at Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. It has been a very dramatic series. The Cubs have won two of the first three games in this final four-game series. Let's go back to Thursday night. In the opener, great defense by the Cubs. Corey Patterson with a sliding play to Jose Macias, to Henry Blanco. Charles Gibson tagged out. That preserved a Cubs 3-2 win in game one. Then Friday night, Todd Walker limped to the plate as a pinch hitter. His first at bat since suffering a knee injury a week before. He delivered the game-winning RBI as the Cubs played it 2 in the ninth against Brad Lidge in a 4-3 victory. Yesterday, just too much Roger Clemens as the Rocket solidified the ERA title and getting his 341st career win. A couple of strikeouts on the day. And then Brad Lidge with a solid comeback performance with a 1-2-3 ninth. The Astros' magic number again is down to one. And as we bring Bob Brenly in and talk about this Cubs season, it will be a sub-500 season. The Cubs trying to finish at 80-82. And injuries are not an excuse, but they are a reason or a factor, and unfortunately a huge factor for the Cubs this year.
Yeah, injuries happen to every ball club over the course of the season. They're unavoidable. The injuries you worry about are the chronic ones, the ones that seem to keep coming back over and over again. And that wasn't the case with most of the Cubs' injuries this year. They were just accidents on the field of play. I mean, these are some very, very key people that Dusty Baker and his staff were counting upon heavily this season. And for me, the loss of Nomar Garciaparra for the amount of time he was gone was a big blow, because this is a club that's built to score a bunch of runs to win ball games, and with Nomar out of the lineup, the offense just sputtered.
And we certainly know about Ramirez and all those other guys. One of the underrated injuries was Chad Fox, because he was relied on in that eighth inning, and he went down very early in the season. Well, Derek Lee, we've been touting him for the MVP all season long. Doubt he's going to win it because of Albert Pujols and Andrew Jones. Those two teams are going to go to the playoffs, but you can't deny what he has done this year.
Well, just because he doesn't take the trophy home does not mean he has not had an MVP type of a season. Look at those numbers. I mean, just amazing. He has had the kind of season that players dream about, and certainly this is a guy that the Cubs would like to lock up, keep him in the fold for a long time, because he's the kind of player you build a team around.
Well, here's what it is for the Cubs now. They try to beat their nemesis, Roy Oswalt, and the Houston Astros. And if the Phillies win and the Astros lose, there will be a one-game playoff tomorrow for the National League wild card. Much more to come here on Changing the Cubs. We'll hear from Dusty Baker, Cubs manager. We'll hear from Nomar Garciaparra and much more. Stay with us from Houston.
Changing the Cubs is brought to you by Pepsi, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball and the Chicago Cubs. Chevy, your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers. And by Dunkin' Donuts.
Every time I thought I got it made. The following takes place between 8 p.m. and 10 p.m. Eastern, Sunday night.
Who are you working for?
Jack Ballard doesn't get second chances.
You better shoot me or help me, but decide now.
You do. Relive the riveting first season, 24, every weekend.
Beginning tonight at 8 Eastern on Superstation WGN.
America's greatest strengths are the generosity and the compassion of the people.
Because of Hurricane Katrina, we come to you not as presidents, but as private citizens.
You know, right now, in the recovery, it's important for those who want to help to make cash donations.
And everyone can help, and every dollar will impact someone's life. So please visit usafreedomcorps.gov for more information.
The people along the Gulf Coast region will need the help of this country for a long time.
On the next 24, Special Agent Jack Bauer uncovers a plot to kill a presidential candidate.
Find out who their target is.
Senator David Palmer.
If Palmer gets hit, he'll tear this country apart.
And the assassins make the first move.
747 just blew up over the Mojave Desert.
But when Jack's own daughter is kidnapped, he's torn between family and duty.
You have no idea what you're getting yourself into.
The clock is reset on the premiere episode of 24 Weekends. Tonight at 8 Eastern on Superstation WGN. Paul Tracy is living life in the fast lane.
And you're riding shotgun.
Race car driver. It's reality at 200 miles per hour. Wednesday night at 8 Eastern on Superstation WGN.
The following takes place between 8 and 10 Eastern Sunday night.
Who are you working for?
Relive the riveting first season. 24 every weekend.
Beginning tonight at 8 Eastern.
Well, Greg Maddux getting ready to take some hacks at Roy Oswalt. And Maddux on the mound will try to end the season at 500. If he gets his 14th win, he'll become the first pitcher ever to win at least 14 games in 18 consecutive seasons. Well, it's been a disappointing season for the Cubs and for Nomar Garciaparra, mainly because he missed 3.5 months in the middle of the year with the groin/abdominal injury suffered in late April. Got off to a slow start, then was injured. He is hitting over 300 since returning, and since Aramis Ramirez went on the disabled list, Nomar has been playing third base. He came back, signed a one-year deal, so nobody knows if he's going to be back in 2006. Earlier in the week at Wrigley, I sat down with Nomar to talk about 05 and a look ahead to 06.
Well, I'm glad to come back. I mean, that was a huge challenge in and of itself this year. A lot of people tell me I wouldn't be able to come back this year. And especially with the injury I had, but I think one, the medical staff here, and then going back and getting myself focused and focusing on trying to get back. I'm just been so happy to come back, and I think with that, probably comes out in the way I'm able to play, because you know I'm really just enjoying every day and just happy to be out there. It's definitely been different. I knew it wasn't going to be easy, and when I went in there and I told myself, I'm not saying this is going to be easy, but. You know, when you see a teammate go down and you want to go out there and you want to help the team as best you can and play, that was really my driving force. It says, hey, you know, this is one way, you know, what do you think? I presented to Dustin. He says, all right, give it a shot, and kind of learning on the fly there and doing it. But, you know, hopefully it has worked out. I mean, I'm going over there learning every day, learning something new every day. But at the same time, you know, you do what you can. And I'm not the only guy who's done it from this team who says, hey, this is what I have to do to try to help the team, or that, you know, I might have to change here and there. I mean, you got Damp going in there and being our closing, done an unbelievable job. Glendon goes out there, and I mean, you can ask him the long relief. I'm sure if you ask him to close, short relief, start, he's done it all. You saw Woody go in there, and you know, he changed from a starter to going in the bullpen. So that's what a team's about, and that's what you do. But he's been great. I mean, he's a guy, I mean, I think people always talk about, I think if he could go out there and grab a bat and play, he would. And and you as a player see that, so you get excited, you go out there, and you play hard day in and day out.
Hammer deep to left field, and it's out!
He's been great. I mean, as a first baseman over there, I mean, I love throwing him. I mean, how can you not when you have that big target over there? And he's just so good on defense out there that saves games. And then from that, going over to the offensive side, he's going over and winning games that way. So he's really done the whole package. I mean, I definitely see him as the MVP when you look at that is, you know, what has he done? He's done everything from both sides to help their team get to, you know, wherever that is. That has a tendency to take care of itself in the off season. I love it here. I mean, I think I've made that evident and said that. I mean, I think hopefully I've showed that, you know, by coming back, you know, this past year. But, you know, hopefully I can come back again next year. I really do. I enjoy the city. I enjoy this organization. I enjoy the fans. I mean, all three of them have been just so classy and just so welcoming that, you know, I really like it here.
Well, pretty classy guy, Nomar Garciaparra. He's getting stretched out and ready for the finale, and he's playing third base once again today for the Cubs. And now in the booth with us, Cubs general manager Jim Hendry. Jim, I want to talk about the season, but we just heard from Nomar, and, you say what if, 3.5 months, but he has hit, I think, .320 since returning from the DL.
Yeah, he swung the bat really well, and, you know, he swung the bat great in spring training. He looked like the Nomar of old, the batting champion Nomar from Boston, and then unfortunately, you know, he got hurt so early in the season. It really put a damper on our offense. And I feel bad for him because he gave us a great effort to get ready for the season coming off of the injuries he had last year and gave a great effort to try to get back and help us late in the year.
If you could give us a summary of the season, I guess, where would you start?
Well, obviously, it's very disappointing. You know, we never thought we would be in a situation where we're in now. We never thought that we would be under 500. We certainly thought we would be coming down to the wire here playing to try to get in. You know, it just didn't work out. We did not play good baseball a lot of days, and no excuses. We just got to do a better job. We got to have a good winter, good off season, and get ready for a great 06.
There have been some bright spots, and one of those guys, in fact, you signed to a 3-year extension yesterday, Ryan Dempster, the closer. The Cubs have not lost a game in which he has had a save opportunity, 33 out of 35.
Yeah, he's been terrific. Terrific guy besides, you know, doing a heck of a job in that ninth inning, which is hard to do. He's a total team guy, wants to win. I think he really made a statement yesterday by signing with us without going out on the free agent market. So we're thrilled to have him back, and you can win a lot of games with Ryan Dempster.
How about the Rock over there at first base, Derek Lee, talking about leadership. He mentioned just being there every day, and it's a quiet leadership, but he certainly led by example all year.
What a phenomenal season. You know, you just don't put up numbers like he did and also be a Gold Glove type defender. You know, he's terrific, great teammate, and we're thrilled to have him, and hopefully he'll be a Cub for a long time.
Well, Jim, from Bob and me, we certainly thank you for all the great information. You really took care of us this year, and I know next year is going to be a lot better, and good luck in the offseason.
Thank you, Lynn.
That's Jim Hendry, Cubs general manager. The Cubs getting set to take on Roy Oswalt and the Houston Astros. We'll hear from Dusty Baker coming up and Paul Sullivan from the Chicago Tribune.
It's a fall to beat 'em all. Sex in the City, 7 nights a week, 24 from the very beginning Sunday nights, and 2 originals, Race Car Driver and the critically acclaimed Da Vinci's Inquest. The home to Sex in the City, 24 and all new originals is right here.
Superstation WGN.
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 WGN. Superstation WGN.
Well, they haven't forgotten the Larry Anderson trade. This Astros fan wants the Astros and the Red Sox in the World Series, and Jeff Bagwell to hit a walk-off home run. Minute Maid Park roof closed today, final game of the 2005 regular season. Well, we're now joined by Paul Sullivan, the Cubs beat writer with the Chicago Tribune, and get his thoughts as we look ahead to 2006. But first, we have to take a look at this 2005 season. Paul, really? In your estimation, how big were the injuries this year?
The injuries were a main factor. Obviously, not having Nomar and not having Kerry Wood in the rotation really hurt them. But, you know, they didn't get the years they expected out of a lot of people. And except for Derek Lee and Ryan Dempster, I think everybody's got to look in the mirror and see what they have to do to improve next year.
In your estimation, where does Jim Hendry start as he looks to retool a part of this roster?
Well, obviously, they got to get a leadoff guy. Furcal's out there. Johnny Damon's out there. They're going to command a lot of money, but you know, the Cubs should have some money to spend this offseason.
Matt Mertin and Ronnie Cedeno made names for themselves as rookies here in 2005. In Cedeno's case, he can play short and possibly second base. In Mertin's case, we've seen him play every day in left field. Do you think the Cubs could go with one or both of those guys in the starting lineup opening day?
I could see him doing both, especially Cedeno, I think, has earned a job. Mertin, now that we've seen him hit against right-handers, like Dusty said earlier, he struggled a little bit. He's like under 250 against right-handers, so he's a little bit more of a question mark defensively, but Cedeno definitely has earned a spot.
What's your gut feeling on Nomar? Do you think he'll be back? And if not, where will he be and what position will he play?
I'm guessing Nomar will be in L.A. personally. He had a good run here when he was playing, but the Cubs have to improve defensively, and I just don't see him playing here.
How about Jeremy Burnett, and a guy who everybody certainly liked having around? He signed in early February and put up Jeremy Burnett's type numbers.
Yeah, Jeremy Burnett's a great guy, and he had a good year, but I don't see them bringing him back for $7 million. Maybe if he gets maybe $3 or $4 million, but I think they'll probably go in another direction in right field. And Corey Patterson, I think, I don't know what they're going to do with him, but I don't know how many more chances you're going to give him.
We just have a few seconds, but being around Dusty this year, I know it was a very frustrating year for him as well.
Yeah, I mean, Dusty didn't have a very good year either. I think he would be the first one to admit that, even injuries aside. But he'll be back next year, and whether he comes back after that is the question we're all going to be asking.
Paul, thanks for the time. We appreciate
it
very
much. Thank you, and you had a good year, too, you and Bob.
Thanks, Paul. Appreciate it. That's Paul Sullivan from the Chicago Tribune. We'll have more to come. Changing the Cubs continues from Houston, Texas, in a moment.
The following takes place between 8 p.m. and 10 p.m. Eastern, Sunday night.
Who are you working for?
Jack Bauer doesn't get second chances.
You better shoot me or help me, but decide now.
You do. Relive the riveting first season, 24, every weekend.
Beginning tonight at 8 Eastern on Superstation WGN.
How much are you paying for internet service? $21? $23? Aren't you being charged too much? We think so. With People PC Online, you get unlimited internet access for only $10.95 a month. Go to peoplepc.com now to try us free for 30 days and compare us with your current ISP. With People PC Online, you get internet service for less than half of what the big guys cost. And that's just the beginning. You also get more local access numbers than AOL, plus a smart dialer that automatically chooses the fastest, most reliable number. So you always get the best connection, all for just $10.95 a month. Try People PC Online free for 30 days and see for yourself. Go to peoplepc.com for a quick 3-minute download of our easy-to-use software. Or call 1-800-727-1741. People PC Online, a better way to internet.
America's greatest strengths are the generosity and the compassion of the people.
Because of Hurricane Katrina, we come to you not as presidents, but as private citizens.
You know, right now, in the recovery, it's important for those who want to help to make cash donations.
And everyone can help, and every dollar will impact someone's life. So please visit usafreedomcorps.gov for more information.
The people along the Gulf Coast region will need the help of this country for a long time.
It's our pleasure to be joined by the skipper before the final game of the 2005 season. And Dusty, you know, looking back at the year, I know it's tough to do. Things tend to leave your memory quickly when they're not going well. But looking back over the whole season, just kind of your overview of how the year went.
Well, I mean, the whole year was a struggle to me from the beginning. You know, we never had that period. I think max we won is six in a row. That period where you reel off 7, 8, 9, 10 games in a row. And it was just a struggle, you know, trying to find bodies for a while. Also, at the same time, you know, we had some young players that are trying to find their way at a young bullpen. But all in all, I mean, it was I can't say it was a good year, but I can't say it was exactly a bad year either, because we did find out some things. Some guys had some very good years. Certainly, we're not where we want to be. But, you know, to me, there are a lot of factors in there that you know, really don't matter other than they were factors. And so, you know, to me, when I look back upon this year, it's a year where we can use, hopefully, to never return again, you know, to make it better in the future.
You know, and some of the things that that maybe worked against you guys this year could turn out to be a positive next year. You mentioned the young bullpen. A lot of those guys were thrown into the fire maybe a little bit before their time, but perhaps the experience that they had this year will make them better next year.
Well, that's how I look at it, especially you got guys like Omen. You know, I mean, he was slated to be the second lefty, ended up being your first lefty. You know, later in the ball game, you got Noboa, which we thought was going to be used hopefully in the fifth and sixth, and we're using him in the seventh and eighth. You know, we got guys like, you know, Wellmeyer that's trying to find his, you know, find his control of the strike zone. We got guys like Sergio that was in between starting and relieving. You know, like I said, we have a young bullpen, but these guys, you know, really gained a lot of confidence, gained a lot of poise, and they've gotten better as the season went on.
You know, and even, Dusty, for teams that do go to postseason baseball, it seems like there's a lot of change every year. Rosters turn over, players come and go. And certainly it figures that there'll be some changes on this Cubs team looking forward to next year. Will that change your approach at all? If you have guys coming from other organizations or more young kids coming up from the minor leagues, will that change the way you guys go about your preparation in spring training?
Possibly. Depends who those players are. You know, if you get a fundamentally sound player, that makes it a lot easier. Or if you get young players that come from different places where they really teach fundamentals, you just have to see. I mean, you know, every time you change personnel, it changes the equation and the personality of the ball club. So the one thing I've noticed is that you have to teach more now at the big league level than ever before. Just you teach things that you assume that they know, which is one thing Roger Craig told me when I first got started, is to never assume that they know. And sometimes you fall into that and you assume that they do know. And a lot of times you don't know what a person doesn't know until they make a mistake. You know, there is no 101 baseball manual that you hand out that you give a pop quiz that everybody has to pass or fail. You know, a lot of it is you learn as you go what they know or don't know. And the thing about it is we just have to go back to the drawing board. We're going to have to keep stressing the things that I know are best and conducive for playing winning baseball, and stress them every day, especially like signs and little things that you assume, you know. You know, hitting a cutoff man, being in the proper position. There's all kind of things that, you know, that you think about, you know, that cost you ball games or win you ball games. Like last night, that was a perfectly executed cutoff and relay last night. You know, can you do that every time? Probably not. Do you want them to do it all the time? Yeah, most definitely so. And so there's a lot of things that, you know, a lot of it depends on the personnel that you have.
You know, Dusty, you've taken a couple teams into the postseason in your career, and you know, there's been a lot of discussion lately. What's better, to clinch early so you can kind of rest some of your guys, get them ready for the postseason, or like in the case of the Astros, they're going to battle right down to the wire here to see if they go to the postseason. Do you think one or the other is an advantage?
Well, you know, Sam, I've seen both ways. And sometimes it's good to keep playing on one side, you know, so you keep that competitive edge and the juices flowing. On the other side, it is good to get some guys some rest and set your bullpen for the postseason, especially in that first round. That first round is best of five. And so, you know, if we take them all the way to Sunday, then, you know, they were counting on probably Oswald going that first game. But on the other hand, you know, you want to, you know, I'd like to clinch preferably about 3 or 4 days before the end of the season. I mean, that way I can set my rotation. You can give a guy a day off here, day off there, play him a half a game for 3 or 4 games and make sure that they keep that sharpness, but not, you know, but not injure them. So, you know, personally, I just want to get there. I don't care how many games we win.
It doesn't matter how you get there. You just want to get there. Well, Dusty, I know it's been a trying season at times this year, but I know you always kept your head up. You always kept pushing forward, and enjoy your off season with your family. I know you'll be out fishing and hunting and doing some things, but it won't be long till we're back in Mesa getting after it again.
Well, hey, man, I'm looking forward to it.
All right, Dusty. Thank you.
And thanks to Bob and Dusty. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we saved the best for last. Derek Lee certainly has been the Cubs MVP, if not the best player in all of baseball here in 2005. We're going to take a look back at one of the greatest seasons any Cubs player has ever had. Who did we think Derek Lee was? We think he was the MVP.
Changing the Cubs has been brought to you by Pepsi, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball and the Chicago Cubs. Chevy, your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers. And by Dunkin' Donuts.
Still don't know what I was looking for, and my time was running wild, a million dead end streets. Every time I thought I got it made, it seemed the taste.
On the next 24, Special Agent Jack Bauer uncovers a plot to kill a presidential candidate.
Find out who their target is.
Senator David Palmer.
If Palmer gets hit, they'll tear this country apart.
And the assassins make the first move.
747 just blew up over the Mojave Desert.
But when Jack's own daughter is kidnapped, he's torn between family and duty.
You have no idea what you're getting yourself into.
The clock is reset on the premiere episode of 24 Weekends. Tonight at 8 Eastern on Superstation WGN.
Calling the Mach 5. Come in, Speed. Trixie, calling the Mach 5.
I'm in the middle of a race, Trixie. Don't talk to me now.
Speed, listen to me. The bridge is out ahead. You're in extreme danger.
The bridge is out?
Don't worry, Speed. I have good news.
Tell me, Trixie.
I just saved a bunch of money on my car insurance by switching to Geico.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Hey, Cubs fans, keep your eye on the ball. Every time a Cubs player hits a homer at Wrigley, you could be a winner. It's the Southwest Airlines How Far Did It Fly Home Run Contest. After every Cubs homer, write down the distance along with your name and address and send it to WGN-TV. 10 winners will receive 2 round-trip tickets to any Southwest Airlines destination. For every Cubs homer, ask yourself, how far did it fly? From Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the Chicago Cubs.
America's greatest strengths are the generosity and the compassion of the people.
Because of Hurricane Katrina, we come to you not as presidents, but as private citizens.
You know, right now, in the recovery, it's important for those who want to help to make cash donations.
And everyone can help, and every dollar will impact someone's life. So please visit usafreedomcorps.gov for more information.
The people along the Gulf Coast region will need the help of this country for a long time.
The following takes place between 8 and 10 Eastern Sunday night.
Who are you working for?
24.
Beginning tonight at 8 Eastern.
The following is a presentation of WGN Sports.
Inside Minute Maid Park here in Houston as WGN Sports presents Chicago Cubs baseball for the final time here in 2005. The Cubs wrap up the 05 season. The Astros certainly want to continue their season into the playoffs, their magic number to clinch the National League wild card down to 1. The Cubs try to finish up at 80-82. And we greet you for the final time here on WGN for 05. Bob Brenly and Len Casper, thanks for joining us all season long. And it's been a disappointing season for the Cubs as a team, but not for Derek Lee personally. I know he's disappointed because the Cubs haven't played better, but you just want him to get one hit. How about a home run today and a couple of nice round numbers to go for?
Well, obviously, we're all rooting for Derek to accomplish those last few remaining things that he needs to do to put the cherry on the sundae that's been the 05 season. Just a remarkable year for a remarkable ball player.
With one extra base hit, he'll get to 100. It would also get to 200 hits on the campaign, has a chance for a batting title, and Greg Maddux has a chance to end the season at 500.
It's not much consolation for Mad Dog, but you know he's going to go out there and give it everything he has. When Dusty asked him if he wanted this opportunity to pitch on the final day, he says, heck yeah, I just enjoy pitching.
Roy Oswalt goes for his 20th win today for Houston, and the Cubs would like nothing better than to beat Oswalt and the Astros.
Yeah, they banged him around pretty good this year. In 12 innings against the Cubs, he's given up 18 base hits and 7 runs. Hopefully more of the same today.
So the Astros, if they win, they are in. If they lose and the Phillies win, they'll have a one-game playoff in Philadelphia tomorrow afternoon. A lot of energy inside Minute Maid Park. We'll have all the action coming up. It's the Cubs and the Astros right here on WGN Sports.
J. Chicago Cubs baseball, brought to you by Bud Light. Smooth and refreshing Bud Light. Great taste for your great times. The Illinois Lottery. No matter how you play, play the Illinois Lottery. Have a ball. Pepsi, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball and the Chicago Cubs. Comcast. Catch the Cubs home games on WGN and HDTV on Comcast. Call for a great offer. And by Southwest Airlines. Nonstop service to 59 destinations all across the country. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom.
The following takes place between 8 p.m. and 10 p.m. Eastern, Sunday night.
Who are you working for?
Jack Ballard doesn't get second chances.
You better shoot me or help me, but decide now.
You do. Relive the riveting first season, 24 every weekend.
Beginning tonight at 8 Eastern on Superstation WGN.
Smooth from the first taste. Refreshing every single time. The great taste of Bud Light. The summer is calling, and so are the friends. Bud Light. Great taste for your great times.
Right now, you can get up to $500 off select John Deere riding lawn tractors. Plus, no interest and no payments until April 2006. But hurry into your nearest John Deere dealer because this window of opportunity will soon be closed.
Starting Tuesday at McDonald's, win hot electronics and cool cash. With the biggest Monopoly game ever.
Help Point, how can I help you?
Hi, listen, I just got rear-ended by some yahoo.
Are you okay?
Well, I'm fine. My car is a little busted up, though.
No problem. We'll take care of it.
How fast can Farmers Help Point service get your car fixed after an accident? Well, you get the idea. Help Point is free with your policy. To find an agent near you, call 1-800-FARMERS.
Michael Barrett in the lineup and some hugs on the bench. Final regular season game, final game for the Cubs here in 2005. And boy, as it always happens, I mean, no team, whether you win a World Series, whether you finish in fourth, which the Cubs will in the National League Central, it always changes. Same 25-man roster, 40-man roster will not happen next year, and the Cubs look to make some changes on their rosters. So this is a final time this current group will be together on the same baseball field. We noticed yesterday, you pointed out that this crowd here in Houston seemed a bit apprehensive. The Astros had lost the first two games of this series. The Phillies surging and the lead down to one game. But after the Astros won and clinched at least a tie, there is a ton of energy in this ballpark.
Yeah, there really is. At least going into the ballgame, it feels much different than yesterday's game. I think, as I said at the time, it's a byproduct of the Astros' inability to score runs, enough runs for their pitching staff, especially with the Rocket on the mound yesterday. He's been shut out, or the Astros rather, have been shut out nine times when Clemens has taken the mound, and I think the fans were anticipating more of the same yesterday.
Phillies and the Nationals are scoreless in the fourth inning. Phillies are batting John Lieber and Hector Carrasco. The pitchers will keep you posted as the day moves along. Final Cubs Pepsi lineup here in 2005. Corey Patterson hitting 286 against Roy Oswalt. He's leading off. The other reason is Nathy Perez has been bothered by a sore left wrist. Nathy is in the lineup, but he is batting eighth this afternoon.
Take a look at the Astros defensively. Berkman, Taveras, and Lane once again across the outfield. Willie Taveras, candidate for the Rookie of the Year award. Morgan Ensberg, Adam Everett, Craig Biggio, and Mike Lamb across the infield. Brad Ausmus behind the plate today for the right-hander, Roy Oswalt. Oswalt had an outstanding month of September when he went 4-1 with an ERA of under 2.5. I mentioned his numbers against the Cubs this season. He's faced him twice. First time was a 9-3 win. The second time a 4-2 loss. But in his 12 innings pitched, he surrendered 18 base hits and 7 runs.
And the umpires today, Bill Cuzzi is behind the plate. The crew chief, Jerry Crawford at first. Ed Rapuano and C.B. Buckner second and third, respectively. Roof was open the first two nights of this series, but closed yesterday and again today. Greg Maddux this afternoon making his team best 35th start. Number 35 for Oswald as well. He was the only 20 game winner in the National League last year. He went 20-10 and finished third in the Cy Young voting.
Oswald, a four pitch guy, fast curve, slider, change. The curveball is the pitch that you may see featured today. He throws it at a variety of different speeds, occasionally in the low 60s.
Patterson swings at the first pitch. Willie Taveras out at center will make the catch. One pitch and one out. And Jose Macias will come up. .72 inside, .89 outside. And ball one on Jose. Cubs will charter home after this one. Some guys will return to Chicago. Others have already made plans to head to their winter destination right after this one.
It's a very odd scenario after the last game of the season when you're not headed to the postseason. I vividly remember a game we finished with the San Francisco Giants in Cincinnati, and guys were literally leaving the ballpark in cabs with their uniforms on. Played a very slow, long game, and some guys had flights to catch to go to their homes in various parts of the country, and took off out of the ballpark with their unis on and changed at the airport. Fans hoping home plate umpire Phil Cuzzi already here in the first inning today. They tried to help as much as they could yesterday for C.B. Buckner as well.
Yeah, they've been a little squirrely here with a strike zone for the Astros pitchers. C.B. Buckner in a conversation with Phil Garner. Roger Clemens said he told him, don't pay attention to me today. I woke up on the wrong side of bed. Ground ball right to Ensberg. So sometimes it looks like a player is arguing with an umpire, when in the case of Clemens yesterday, he claims he told Buckner, don't worry about me. Phil Garner wanted to know what it was all about. Derek Lee starting the day at 337, 7 points ahead of Albert Pujols. Cardinals hosting the Reds this afternoon. In a few minutes, we'll check on Pujols. Derek needs one extra base hit. He could kill two birds with one stone, because it would also be his 200th hit. He has 99 extra base hits, 199 hits overall. What a year. And right now, hitting 71 points higher than his career average going into 2005. He was at 266. But this year, hitting 337.
And a number we kind of overlook with Derek Lee is the fact he scored 120 runs this year. He's been getting on that plate with regularity.
Two-two the count on him. Phillies with a tally in the fourth inning. The Astros have their bags packed. I'm sure they didn't want to have them packed, but they had to come to the ballpark thinking it's possible they could travel to Philadelphia. And if they have a one game playoff, it would be at 3 o'clock Central tomorrow afternoon. We just got a piece of it. If the Astros clinch, they'll have a workout here tomorrow. And I think Tuesday would head to Atlanta for the division series, which would start on Wednesday. And you can't just pack for Philadelphia. You have to pack for Philly and Atlanta. That gets confusing as well. The traveling secretary for whatever team is involved in that situation just says, hey, pack for 4 days.
Got to cover every possible scenario. This is one of those times where the traveling secretaries really earn their money. They make hotel reservations in a couple of different cities. Buses, planes.
Lee strikes out. That ends the Cubs first. Maddox will take the ball and face the Astros when we come back.
Do you have a dinosaur?
No.
Do you have a mummy?
No.
Do you have the space shuttle?
No.
What do you have?
Well, we have a display of the local gopher in its natural habitat.
That's not a gopher.
Yeah, it is.
Take them to a place that has it all. Fly Southwest Airlines from Chicago Midway to BWI Airport for just $89 one way.
You are now free to move about the country.
Dual-action tailgate, and an industry-first lockable in-bed trunk. The Ridgeline from Honda.
Hey, that looked like my fish.
This is our marathon station. We own it. We run it, and, you know, we're proud to be part of this community.
My name's on the door, so everything's got to be right. I mean, these people know me, and I want to take care of them.
When you're an independent dealer, your reputation's on the line every day.
But it's not just about running a business for us. It's about being a part of a community that we care about.
We know what our customers want because we know our customers.
Helping friends and neighbors, that's the spirit of America. Marathon, fueling the American spirit.
Now the Astros starting lineup 1-8 exactly the same as yesterday when they beat the Cubs 3-1. Cubs still playing well against the Astros this year, 9-6 overall.
Take a look at the Cubs defensively, brought to you by Pepsi. Merton, Patterson, Burnett once again across the outfield. Garcia, Parra, Perez, Macias, and Lee once again across the infield. Michael Barrett starting the final game of the 05 season behind the plate. For the future Hall of Famer, Greg Maddux.
Right now, Maddux is tied with Phil Niekro for 15th on the all-time wins list with 318. So he could grab sole possession of 15th with a win. He'll be back next year. He'll turn 40 early on next season. And a 1-0 to Biggio, hit hard on the ground. It's past Nomar. Nathy going out to get it, but Biggio with a leadoff double. He led off the game yesterday with a home run.
For the 604th time in his career, Craig Biggio with a double, this time right inside the line at third. Headed for that left field corner, but hits the message board out there on the front of the bleachers in left field and ricochets back toward the infield. Nathy very alertly hustled out there to get the ball, but Biggio cruised into second easily.
So 139-year-old doubling off another. Willie Tavares will bunt foul. The Astros will just try to chip away and get a run here, a run there, and hope their pitching holds up. That's been the formula for most of 2005. Bill Garner took over in the middle of last year for Jimmy Williams. The Astros won the wild card in 04.
I really think we're giving Tavares a little bit too much room here. He's going to bunt.
Maddox off the mound. He didn't even look at third. Just went right at Derek Lee, got the out there. And Biggio 90 feet away with one out.
Now Maddox may have had a play at third base there. He was just conceding the runner was going to advance. The ball was bunted fairly hard back to him. He gets to it quickly. But as you mentioned, he never even took a peek. He just wants to go ahead, get that out at first base and go to work on the next hitter. And Biggio's busting. He thinks he's going to have a play at third base right there, but very glad to see Maddox come up and go to first.
Yeah. Ensberg dunks one into left, and the Astros on the board. 1-0. Morgan Ensberg with his 101st RBI.
I had a coach very early in my career that talking about a hitter said, when the ball lands, it don't even bend the grass. That was a very soft line drive there. Full swing from Ensberg. He gets jammed and just muscles it out into shallow left field. Didn't even bend the grass.
Astros trying to clinch their sixth postseason appearance the last 9 years. Berkman bounces it softly to Lee. Derek is going to tag Berkman. He had to work around Greg Maddux.
You got two great fielders going after the same ball. Which one's going to give? I got more gold gloves than you. Yeah, but I have the baseball. Get out of the way. I'm going to tag it.
Now they have 15 combined. Maddux with 14. Derek Lee with a great chance to win his second this year. Mike Lamb, the first baseman. 1-for-4 yesterday. He's 1-for-8 against Greg Maddux. Greg has not finished under 500 since 1987. If he wins his 14th today, he would be the first pitcher ever to win at least 14 in 18 straight years. We have been stuck on 15 for obvious reasons because he won 15 in 17 consecutive years, but you just kind of adjust the number. And it's got to be strange for Greg Maddux. No postseason action for the second straight year. He was in the playoffs every year with Atlanta. From 93 to 03, except for 94 when the season was canceled in August because of the strike. Base hit. Ensberg's going to be set. There's going to be a play at the plate. Here it is, and he's saved. And it's 2-0.
Burnett's with a good charge in right field, a strong throw right on line to home plate. Just enough room for Ensberg to slide around Michael Barrett at the plate. You see he had to go out to get that ball. It's a tough habit to break for a catcher. You're much better served just sitting back on the plate and letting the ball come to you.
Mayfield over to Macias. Inning ends. 3 hits, 2 runs, 1 left. They're excited here in Houston because their Astros have an early 2-0 lead.
The following takes place between 8 and 10 Eastern Sunday night.
Who are you working for?
Jack Bauer doesn't get second chances.
Shoot me or help me, but decide now.
You do. Relive the riveting first season. 24 every weekend.
Beginning tonight at 8 Eastern.
Hey, I'll take one of those chickens.
Sure. Which one?
Thousand hand slap.
I'm gonna go with that one.
Good choice.
It takes a family to make a house a home.
and a home to turn a dream into a future. So if you have a dream...
In Chicago, I'm your man. I'm an Ameriquest mortgage specialist.
So if you're thinking of buying a home or refinancing...
I'll help you pay off your high-interest credit cards and lower your monthly payments.
I'm an Ameriquest mortgage specialist, and I'm here to help you with your dream.
Call 1-800-AMERIQUEST or visit ameriquest.com. Ameriquest Mortgage, proud sponsor of the American Dream.
Choosing a new low-cost internet service? Check this out. With Netscape's new Web Accelerator, I can surf up to 5 times faster than standard dial-up. And with Netscape, I get Web Accelerator for just $9.95.
Net Zero charges $14.95 for that.
Same speed, less money.
Works for me.
Get Netscape with new Web Accelerator and surf up to 5 times faster for just $9.95. That's over 30% less than Net Zero.
It's just the net you need.
Now Morgan Ensberg on the left, Mike Lamb on the right, each with an RBI hit in the opening inning against Greg Maddux. So very quickly, Roy Oswalt with a 2-0 edge as he works here in the second.
I said off the air, 6 hitters went to the plate for the Astros in that first inning. Greg Maddux only threw 12 pitches. An awful lot of stuff happened for only throwing 12 pitches.
3 hits and 2 runs. Nomar fouls away. 8-game hitting streak. Nomar 5-for-12 in this series. 34th start. At the hot corner, will it be his final game in a Cubs uniform? Nobody knows for sure. O-2 is fouled off again. Good fastball from Oswalt at 95 here early on. The Cubs will finish in fourth in the National League Central. They're 2 back of Milwaukee, 6 up on Cincinnati. They'll finish under 500 for the first time since 2002. After back-to-back winning seasons. The strange thing is the Cubs won 89 last year, did not make the postseason. Well, 89 would have gotten them the wild card this year because Houston has 88. Oswalt again, fouled right at the plate. Hey, Cub fans, don't forget to visit our WGN baseball blog. Tons of great stuff on the blog today. Bob and I each have a post offering our thank yous to all of you, the greatest fans in baseball. We have a couple of great photo galleries from our day in the bleachers and shots of Wrigley from the rooftops. That's brought to you by Dunkin' Donuts. Swing and a miss and a strikeout, number 2 for Oswalt.
A lot of mid 90s fastballs early in the going here from Roy Oswalt. Throws that one up above the letters to Nomar. Had him in kind of a swing at everything mode up there at the plate and just went up the ladder with a 93 mile an hour heater. Got into chase.
They love him here. Outside on Burnett's. Could be Burnett's final game. As a Cub, Cubs have an option on him for next year. He can get his 25th home run. That would get him to 300 for his career. He's 3 RBIs away from 90 here in 05. And thanks to Cubs general manager Jim Hendry for joining us on Changing the Cubs, our half hour pregame special. Two on Burnett's. Called strike 3. 3 straight K's for Oswalt.
Sometimes when a pitcher has, I don't want to call it a gimmick pitch, but a go-to pitch like the big curveball that Oswald has, a hitter will catch himself, okay, he's got to throw it right here. He hadn't shown it to me the whole sequence. He's got to throw me that curveball at some point. And you end up taking a pretty good pitch right down the middle of the plate. Tough guy to guess along with, especially in the early going.
How is it that a guy who's 6 feet tall, 185 pounds, throws as hard as Oswald does, and then you see some left-handers who are 6'6", and they plop it up there at 89. It's funny how it works.
If you can figure out how a guy the stature of Roy Oswalt generates the velocity that he does as consistently as he does, you'd probably be a real good big league pitching coach.
Jordan, good mechanics help.
Mechanics help a lot. He's been blessed with a very elastic throwing arm.
Barrett swings and misses. Oswald fans aside in the second. 2-0 Houston.
The smooth taste that gets things started. The refreshing taste that keeps things going. Where will you find the great taste of Bud Light? Wherever good friends get together. And wherever good times are going on and on. Bud Light. Great taste for your great times.
Right now, you can get up to $500 off select John Deere riding lawn tractors. Plus, no interest and no payments until April 2006. But hurry into your nearest John Deere dealer because this window of opportunity will soon be closed.
Jim's best friend died of a heart attack with no warning, and I worried it could happen to Jim. His doctor said you should always have Genuine Bear at hand. Just one has enough aspirin to help save your life during a heart attack.
We both feel better when I have my Bear.
It was my first team.
It was my first time under pressure.
My first feeling of pride.
It was my first big break.
My first moment to shine.
My first shot at success.
It was my first job.
My first job.
It was my first job.
But what I learned there
will last forever.
Please join McDonald's in thanking the restaurant crew and managers who serve you every day.
This portion of Chicago Cubs baseball on WGN is brought to you by CarQuest. 3,600 CarQuest auto parts stores across North America.
If a Cubs player hits a homer today, write down the distance and player's name and send it to WGN-TV. You could win 2 round-trip tickets to any Southwest Airlines destination.
WGN Sports coverage of Cubs baseball from Houston is brought to you by Bud Light. Smooth and refreshing Bud Light. Great taste for your great times.
Astros want the wild card. Let's see, they were in Chicago. They're now in Houston. Wow, they're under the Astros now.
It's all right. They've been disowned as Cub fans anyway.
Ausmus, Everett, and Oswald against Greg Maddux. That's just pitch number 13 on the day for Maddux. Cy Young won at least 14 games in 18 seasons, but not consecutively. Roger Clemens has 341. Wins, number one among active pitchers. The guy who's number two is on the mound right now. With 318. That's his career ERA at 3.01. Fair ball backhanded by Nomar. One out. The last time Maddux's career ERA was in the threes at the end of a season was in 1994 when he ended the year at 3.02, but ended this year at 2.95.
Nice backhand play by Nomar. Long throw across to D. Lee. Yeah, such a routine play. At least it looks like a routine play over there at first for Derek, the way he's able to stretch off that bag, catch the throw, and still avoid the runner coming down that baseline. We just take it for granted, but he does it so flawlessly.
Albert Pujols is 0 for 1. Cardinals hosting Cincinnati today. Derek Lee is 0 for 1 in this one. Everett thrown out by Garcia Parra. Two down. Phillies 2, Nationals nothing in D.C. John Lieber to this point with 4 scoreless innings. The Red Sox are in the exact same situation the Astros are in. They're up a game on Cleveland in the wild card. Here on the final day of the season, Cleveland down at home against the White Sox 3-0 after 4 innings. Yankees and Red Sox just underway in the first, no score. Well, they told the Indians, bring your luggage. The Indians, the best they can hope for is to tie the Red Sox and head to Fenway for that one game playoff tomorrow. So you could possibly have 2 regular season. I mean, they are considered regular season games, but one game playoffs in each league.
Well, I'm all for it. The more baseball we can play between now and the end of the World Series, the happier I am.
Off the end of the bat, foul.
I like to see every series go to the limit. 5 games in the division series, 7 games in the league championship series and World Series, because when it's over, it's over. And we don't get baseball again till spring training.
Pop up right near the plate, and it's bad to make the catch to the 3rd inning from Houston. Astros 2, Cubs nothing.
We got you something. Southwest has new leather seats and roomier cabins for more comfortable flights.
I love leather.
You are now free to move about the country.
Where are you going?
A dual action tailgate. And an industry-first lockable in-bed trunk. The Ridgeline from Honda.
Hey, that looked like my fish.
Dell has great deals on PCs waiting for you now. Get this Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 4 processor for only $599. Plus, get a free flat panel upgrade. Other Dell desktops start at $349. Get more out of now. Dell PCs use Intel Pentium 4 processors.
On the premiere of 24 Weekends, Special Agent Jack Bauer uncovers a plot to kill a presidential candidate.
If Palmer gets hit, he'll tear this country apart.
But when Jack's own daughter is kidnapped, he's torn between family and duty.
You have no idea what you're getting yourself into.
On the premiere episode of 24 Weekend, tonight at 8 Eastern on Superstation WGN.
3rd inning, 2-0 Houston. We have a ton of people to thank today, and we wish we could thank everybody with WGN and the Chicago Cubs, but we will get to as many people as we possibly can here today. Matt Merton leading off the 3rd inning. Roy Oswalt with 4 consecutive strikeouts. He has retired the first six he has faced. Busted bat. Wow, that thing shattered. I almost hit Phil Cuzzy. Coming back around the barrel. Just completely disintegrated. And almost got a good piece of the home plate umpire.
Boy, obviously a very dangerous situation here as you see Merton get jammed here. As he finished his backswing, the barrel part, the heavy part of the bat snapped off from the handle, and as you said, came very close to hitting the home plate umpire right there. Fortunately, everybody okay.
Nathy battling right now. Left wrist has been bothering him for some time on a feet first slide. He's kind of jammed his left wrist. He's 2 for his last 19. 0-for-4 yesterday, but he's trying to get through this final day. Batting eighth in the lineup today. Well, we have to start by thanking Pete Toma, Mark Brady, Skip Ellison, Bob Vorwald, and our great WGN production team. It's been a great job all season, and we have mentioned this many times, Bob, but it is a team effort.
It really is. You know, you can look at it in a lot of different ways. The production crews, the starting pitcher, we're just the offense and the defense.
That's a fair ball. Nathy going to try for two. Slides in. He's safe. He's going to try to get the third.
Keep running. That'd be a little league home run if he scores. A good aggressive base running there by Nathy on that little floater down the left field line. He had it in his mind out of the batter's box. He was going to go for two. And very alert. A lot of guys will slide into a base and they're in such a hurry to call timeout and pose for the cameras and brush the dirt off, they don't see where the throw goes. But Nathy sees this throw from Berkman come back into the infield, gets away from Craig Biggio and doesn't even hesitate. Gets to his feet and moves on to third.
Now back by Maddox.
Well, it's a good lesson for young players there. Keep your eye on the ball until you hear an umpire call timeout. That ball was in play and out in no man's land. Nathy got to his feet and just kept running.
A double and an error on the left fielder Berkman. Fifth error of the series. Squeeze play was on, bunted back to the screen. Not the end of the world if you're the offensive team. You'd rather have that happen than a pop out to the catcher or something, but here comes Nathy.
Well, probably the toughest pitch to get on the ground is a 95 mile an hour fastball at your neck. Maddox was fortunate just to get a piece of that ball, protect his base runner, and continue the at bat. I've always been a proponent of the two strike squeeze with a pitcher myself. You know, Greg Maddux handles the bat pretty well. But most teams, once you get to two strikes, they figure, well, the squeeze is off. Let's just go to work here on the hitter.
Bounce. Nathy's trying to score. The throw to the plate beats him by a mile. The fielder's choice for Maddux. And Nathy gunned down 6-2.
You rarely see a contact play with the pitcher at the plate and the infield drawn in like they are here for the Astros. And Nathy's just got nowhere to go right there. I think a lot of that decision to send him on contact has to do with the fact that Corey Patterson coming to the plate has had such a dismal season trying to drive in runners at any point in a ball game, but especially from third and two outs. So the Cubs rolled the dice, tried to force the Astros into an error, but they executed the play perfectly.
And it gets away from Ausmus. Maddox will end up at second. Nice anticipation from the Cubs pitcher.
You wish all the players had this kind of anticipation. Maddox saw the ball headed for the dirt and broke for second base immediately. He didn't wait to see the ball get away from Brad Ausmus. He read the pitch going into the dirt Got a good break towards second, and Osmus fanned on it back there when he tried to pick up the ball and make a throw.
Patterson hit by a pitch. And he'll take first base. Looks like he's all right.
Ooh, it looked like I'm on the back of that right arm. That could become problematic as this game goes on. Right near the back of that right elbow. Of course, that's Corey's throwing arm.
First and second for Macias. From the WGN production office, we want to thank Bridget Gonzalez, Jeanette Rivera-Rosa, Bill Harriet and the WGN sales team. We want to thank Dan Rohn, Rich King. And the Tribune Tower, Dennis Fitzsimons, Crane Kenny, Pat Mullen, John Batanovic, and everyone at the Tribune Tower. Tom Ellman, Vice President and General Manager of WGN. All the studio coordinators. Cubs down 2-0 here in the third inning. Leafy Perez thrown out at the plate. But the Cubs have two men on with two down. Three and one. Side edge for a strike. And it's 3-2.
I think you'd have to call the strike zone fluid at this point. Both pitchers trying to figure out where they can go to get that called strike, and it's been inconsistent up to this point.
On the hop, nice play by Ensberg. He'll get it over the line, and the inning ends. Cubs strand two. They still trail 2-0.
The following takes place between 8 and 10 Eastern Sunday night.
Who are you working for?
Jack Bauer doesn't get second chances.
Shoot me or help me, but decide now.
You do. We live the riveting first season. 24 every weekend.
Beginning tonight at 8 Eastern.
Always smooth. Right from the start. Always refreshing. Time after time, the days are heating up, and the Bud Light is just right. Bud Light, great taste for your great times.
It's not wood and concrete that build a country. It's dreams and hard work. It's neighbors who give their word along with their hand.
When people around here dream of buying a home
or refinancing,
they call me. I'm an AmeriQuest mortgage specialist.
And I'm here to help you with your dream.
I'll get you the home loan that helps pay off high interest credit cards and lowers your monthly payments. I'll even do the paperwork.
Call 1-800-AmeriQuest or visit AmeriQuest.com. AmeriQuest Mortgage, proud sponsor of the American Dream.
It was my first team.
It was my first time under pressure.
My first feeling of pride.
It was my first big break.
My first moment to shine.
My first shot at success.
It was my first job.
My first job.
It was my first job.
But what I learned there
will last forever.
Please join McDonald's in thanking the restaurant crew and managers who serve you every day.
Well, we got the Astros fan and the Washington Senators cap on. Senators, Nationals. Oh, the Senators way, way, way back when, right?
Yep.
4-0 Phillies in the fifth inning at Washington. Receive in-game alert, scores, breaking news, and more instantly on your mobile phone for only $3.99 per month. Simply text the word Cubs to 65246 or MLB Go from your mobile phone. Top of the order for Houston. Craig Biggio began the game for the Astros offensively with a double and scored on the Ensberg single. Thought about a bunt, took it for ball one. Maddux coming off a complete game performance Tuesday. He has completed three games this year, twice in defeats. He's been a lot better on the road than at home. His ERA about a run less, and he's 10-4 on the road, just 3-10 at Wrigley. Biggio hits it hard on the ground. Oh, off Nomar. Nathie with the throw, save. Well, I hope Nomar's all right. That ball was hit extremely hard. And if he didn't know what playing third base was all about, he sure knows now. Wow.
Why do they call it the hot corner again? Well, just in case you needed a reminder, bad hop at the end of that play came up and hit Nomar in the chest. Turned him completely around, ricocheted directly to Nathie Perez, but unfortunately Biggio runs too well. They weren't able to get him at first base.
So a runner at first and nobody out. Cubs pitch out.
Tavares showing bunt again. I think the Astros are going to try to tack on runs wherever they can in this ball game. We've talked about it throughout this series, throughout the second half of the year. Astros are a ball club that's had trouble scoring runs. And even with a two-run lead, a situation when you would normally just turn your hitters loose at the plate, I think they're going to play for every add-on run they can in this game.
Bunted, but it's foul. Came back up and hit Tavares before he was out of the box. Talked yesterday about Roy Oswalt preparing to start today, and the only way he would not have started is if the Astros had clinched outright, which they were unable to do because the Phillies won yesterday. You have Brandon Backey, who would start tomorrow in Philadelphia should there be a tie. He doesn't want to pitch tomorrow, but again, he has to prepare as if he is. Nomar scoops it up and over to Lee. That's another sacrifice bunt for Tavares, his second of the afternoon. And even if the Astros have a big lead in the ninth inning, if you're Brandon Backey, you can't pop that champagne until the final out is recorded.
Nomar calls off Greg Maddux here, makes a nice play coming across on the sack bunt.
Ball one on Ensberg. Maddux at 31 pitches. Been very efficient here early on. And the Astros have been very aggressive at the plate against him. Saw him change his grip. He had the changeup grip and threw a fastball.
That's something that's caused Maddux considerable problems over the course of his career, with that runner at second base getting the same angle that we get from our center field camera. You can peek right into Greg Maddux's glove, and that's the changeup grip. Switches back to the two-seam fastball grip just in case Craig Biggio out there at second base is attempting to relay anything to the hitter at the plate.
Now, if you stay with a changeup grip, do you have to move your glove as if you're changing? I mean, you try to keep it the same.
I think Maddux over the years has learned to kind of move his glove most of the time. There was a time you could tell when he was going to throw a changeup because he would fan his glove open. But now he fans his glove on just about every pitch, just to not really give that hitter anything to look for. But the runner at second base, however, can see into the glove and can see what Greg Maddux is doing with his grip. Well, you saw him go to the changeup and back to the two-seamer on the last pitch. He had the changeup grip and stayed with the changeup.
Nathy will throw to Nomar. Tag applied. So Biggio out. Each team with a base runner thrown out. Trying to advance a base. Nathy was trying to score. And Biggio was trying to get to third.
It was a poor base running play by Craig Biggio. Kind of shocking for a veteran with his years in the major leagues. And one of his specialties has been his ability to run the bases. But this is just bad fundamental baseball right here. Ball hit right to the shortstop. Nathy barely had to move. And Biggio thrown out easily at third base.
Knee-high strike on Berkman. Maddux steps off. Of course, the Yankees clinched the American League East yesterday, their eighth straight division title. They trailed the Red Sox by 5.5, going into action on August 11th, 35-12 since. The White Sox would play Boston in the first round if the Red Sox are the wild card. If Cleveland gets in, the White Sox would play the Angels. White Sox will start up Tuesday. Berkman with a fly ball and a lazy pop fly, and it's Merton to make the catch. Third inning in the books. 2-0 Houston.
Get up to $500 off select John Deere riding lawn tractors. Plus, no interest and no payments until April 2006. But hurry into your nearest John Deere dealer because this window of opportunity will soon be closed.
I own this Marathon station, and I'm proud to be part of this community.
That's why at my Marathon station, we treat you the way we would want to be treated.
It's like neighbor helping neighbor around here, and I love that.
We know what our customers want. We see these people every day.
It may sound simple, but we work hard to serve you better.
That's the American spirit. And I believe you'll find that at Marathon.
Marathon, fueling the American spirit.
Jim's best friend died of a heart attack with no warning, and I worried it could happen to Jim. His doctor said you should always have Genuine Bear at hand. Just one has enough aspirin to help save your life during a heart attack.
We both feel better when I have my Bear.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by the authority of the Chicago Cubs and may not be reproduced nor retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and description of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Chicago Cubs.
Well, obviously a Rhino fan here in Houston. 2-0 Astros. Sign up for a subscription to Vineline, the official monthly magazine of the Cubs. Vineline offers its readers exclusive player features, team analysis, and unparalleled minor league coverage every month. Subscription started just $24.95. They're going to take a look at the young guys coming up. A photo opportunity on the last homestand. 800-248-9467 is the number. Now back by Derek Lee. Now let go of the bat with his left hand at the end of that swing. He's 0 for 1. With a strikeout today, average right now at 337. Breaking ball inside. Albert Pujols is 0 for 1. He's at 330. Derek Lee, when asked about leadership, said this, quote, "If leadership is being there when the team needs you, I think I did that. I'm proud of that. Hopefully I can do that again next year."
Well, it's frightening to think where the Cubs season would have gone had Derek Lee not had the kind of year he did, or if Derek Lee was one of the guys that had gotten hurt early in the season and they would have missed those offensive numbers.
He went around. Cuzzy with the call back of the plate. And Derek has struck out twice. He went 0 for 2 with 2 strikeouts yesterday, walked twice.
Took a little slider just off the plate down low and away. That's probably Oswalt's fourth best pitch, but he will go to it in certain fastball situations, and he disguises it well enough that it appears to be a fastball as it comes up to the plate and then just slides away from the right-handed hitter.
Jimmy Rollins' hitting streak is at 36. He has 2 hits today. If the Phillies season ends today, they'll have all winter to think about, can I hit in 20 more next year to tie the all-time record set by Joe DiMaggio? But he's going to be asked about it every single day. Now, DiMaggio still would have the single season record, but Rollins could still set a new record for the longest hit streak ever. Hinsberg is over, and he can't make the catch. Kind of stopped before he got to the barrier. Tell you what, he got over there in a big time hurry, but then held up at the last second.
That's where he probably would have been better served to take another step or two, get over to the edge of the wall, and then adjust to the baseball. And when you're trying to watch the ball and out of your peripheral vision, see where that wall is, that's a tough play to make. You teach those corner infielders, corner outfielders for that matter, and catchers, when they have to go over there near the stands, get to the rail as quick as you can and then make your adjustments.
And Ausmus wanted time. Oswalt 19-12 on the year. And he blows away Jeremy Burnett for his 6th strikeout. Astros 2, Cubs nothing.
On the premiere of 24 Weekends, Special Agent Jack Bauer uncovers a plot to kill a presidential candidate.
If Palmer gets hit, we'll tear this country apart.
But when Jack's own daughter is kidnapped, he's torn between family and duty.
You have no idea what you're getting yourself into.
On the premiere episode of 24 Weekend, tonight at 8 Eastern on Superstation WGN.
Destination smell. Introducing Southwest Airlines' new nonstop service to Fort Myers, Naples. Fly from Chicago Midway for just $79 one way.
You are now free to move about the country.
Action tailgate and an industry first lockable in-bed trunk. The Ridgeline from Honda.
Hey, that looked like my fish.
Starting Tuesday at McDonald's, win hot electronics and cool cash. With the biggest Monopoly game ever.
Right now, you can get up to $500 off select John Deere riding lawn tractors. Plus, no interest and no payments until April 2006. But hurry into your nearest John Deere dealer because this window of opportunity will soon be closed.
2-0 Houston. They'll bat in the fourth, but before that happens, let's pause for station ID.
This is America's home for sports all year round. Superstation WGN.
Great to have you with us. Final game of the year for the Cubs. Not for the Astros. They'll play either a one-game playoff tomorrow, or they'll head right to Atlanta to start the division series. Phillies lead at Washington 5-0, top of the sixth. But the Phillies need the Cubs to beat the Astros to have a shot. All any team can ask for is only going to the final weekend with a shot, but there's nothing quite like having your own fate in your hands. And the Astros came out, scored two right off the bat. They don't want to have to look at the scoreboard today. They know if they win, they're in.
They take care of their own business. Everything will happen exactly the way they want it to. And that's all you can ask for at this point in the season. Take care of your own business. I was just thinking about it during the break. You know who else has a tough time of it right now? If you're a Houston Astros advance scout, I'm sure they've had to split up their crews, maybe bring a couple guys on board to help out. Somebody had to be watching the Phillies the last few days. And leads it off here in the bottom of the fourth with a clean single into center field. Sure they had scouts on the Braves. On the Padres. Somebody had to see those Phillies, and I'm sure that will be one lengthy advance meeting tomorrow should they have to fly to Philadelphia to play that one game playoff.
Runner at first, nobody out. Jason Lane the hitter. We're in the fourth inning. And Lamb is on the move. It's a hit and run, and it's bounced foul.
There's different teams have different areas of emphasis when you have your advanced scouting meetings. A lot of times you break it up into separate meetings for your starters, for your relievers, and for your hitters. And the hitters also will go over defensively how they want to position themselves against the opposing team. There you see Randy Smith from the Padres along with Randy Reddy, former Padre player, now advancing the Astros for the Padres in the postseason.
Well, they had the Phillies scouted out pretty well because the Astros went 6-0 against Philadelphia this year. I think they went unbeaten last year too. 12 straight wins for the Astros against the Phillies. But you know how baseball works. If they have to play that game, that means nothing.
Absolutely nothing. And if you believe in the laws of averages and the rhythms and cycles of baseball, you might be a little worried if you're an Astros fan going into Philadelphia.
Indians on the board. They still trail 3-1 at home against the White Sox in the bottom of the sixth. At one point, Cleveland had won 17 of 19. But the Tribe has dropped 5 of 6. All those losses by a gut-wrenching one run. Mm. Lined over Jose Macias. Lamb has to stop at second. Two men on with nobody out. Thank you.
after playing hit and run on the first pitch, they just play it straight up the remainder of the at bat, and Jason Lane gets a sinking fastball out over the plate. He too goes back up the middle of the field against Greg Maddux. That's an approach that teams that have had success against Greg Maddux don't try to pull the ball. They try to go up the middle into the opposite field. Wouldn't surprise me to see Osmus try to drop down a sacrifice bunt right here, even with the bottom of the order coming up and a 2-run lead in the ball game. I mean, one way you can look at it, if you feel Garner, if you give up Brad Osmus here with a sacrifice bunt and it's successful, you've got runners at second and third. Now the Cubs have to decide whether to pitch to Adam Everett or walk him to get to Oswalt. If you pitch to Adam Everett and he makes an out, then you've got the pitcher up at the plate with two outs and two runners on. Any one of those guys reaches at the top of the order coming up.
6-4-3 on a double play. So Maddux gets that big ground ball, two outs, runner at third.
Taylor made from Osmus, little three hopper hit right at Nathy Perez. Jose Macias, I tell you, he hasn't played a lot of second base this year, but he does a nice job of getting out of the way of that sliding runner. We saw him yesterday use the base. He bounced off the back of the base toward center field to use the bag to protect himself against the runner.
Maddux would rather go after Oswalt, so he'll walk Everett. Put him at the corners with two outs. Oswalt fouled out with Barrett in the second inning. Enters this at bat at 167 on the year. Lots of strikes from the future Hall of Famer this afternoon. After the 2-run first inning for the Astros, no runs since. Maddux trying to keep it that way. Bounced foul by Oswalt. Today marks the ninth time Greg Maddux has made at least 35 starts in a season. And this year, most innings pitched for Maddux since 2001. He had 233 innings. He started the day today at 219 and two-thirds. Spend the offseason back home in Vegas. Sure, he'll play a lot of golf. And he'll get ready for 2006. Runner moving from first, and Everett takes second. Out of throw. And see, you're going to be heading to Vegas coming up as well.
Yeah, middle of next week, heading to Las Vegas for Parents Weekend. See the big football game between the Rebels and San Diego State. Looking forward to it.
And son Michael will be playing baseball coming up. Nathy will backhand. It'll be a tough throw to Lee. Safe and a run in. Lamb scores. It's 3-0 on the infield single for Roy Oswalt.
Nothing more Nathy could do on that ball. He's on a dead run to his right, has to throw back across his body all the way across the field. And even with the opposing pitcher, the runner going down the first baseline. Couldn't get it across there in time.
Well, a couple of guys today. Mike Lamb, who came in at 233. Though with two hits, an RBI, and a run. And the pitcher, Roy Oswalt, under 170 with an RBI hit.
Now, Lamb's base hit was a matter of a good approach, a good idea of what he was trying to do against Maddox going up the middle of the field. Roy Oswalt was just a well-placed ground ball, and that happens against sinker ball pitchers.
Red Sox have scored first in that game at Fenway. 1-0, they lead the Yankees in the third inning. Line right at Nomar, made the catch for the final out. Astros get three hits in the inning. They score once. Two left, it's 3-0.
Yeah.
Great deals on PCs waiting for you now. Get this Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 4 processor for only $599. Plus, get a free flat panel upgrade. Other Dell desktops start at $349. Get more out of now. Dell PCs use Intel Pentium 4 processors.
I was just hungry.
Mother's dinner not good enough for you?
Sorry.
Oh, you're darn right you're sorry.
Everyone wants the new fresh toasted chicken parmesan sandwich, zesty marinara, melted cheese, only at Subway restaurants.
What if there is a killer out there?
Da Vinci's Inquest, Tuesday night at 8 Eastern on Superstation WGN. Race car driver, it's a reality at 200 miles per hour.
You're riding shotgun.
A Superstation WGN original. Race car driver, Wednesday night at 8 Eastern.
Cubs are down 3-0 after 4 here in Houston. Let's step aside and see what's coming up on WGN.
Get ready. Kiefer Sutherland and the critically acclaimed 24 is coming to Superstation WGN. See it from the first minute. Premieres tonight at 8 Eastern on Superstation WGN.
Phillies with a comfortable lead right now, but they need the Cubs to come back to have a shot at winning the wild card. Best the Phillies can hope for is a one-game playoff tomorrow, which they would host. But that requires an Astros loss as well as a Phillies win. Cubs would like to come back and make it 3 out of 4 to end the season. Yeah, getting a little tighter in Washington. Let's see the Nationals with 3 runs. It's 5-3 in the sixth.
Somebody just went deep. I looked up too late to see who it was, but somebody for the Nationals just hit one into the right field bleachers. Looked like Ryan Church there showing on the monitor here.
Michael Barrett deep to left. Is it going to be fair? It is. And Barrett has tied his career high with his 16th home run. It's 3-1. Michael enjoyed that one off his nemesis, Roy Oswalt. There was a little hesitation from C.B. Buckner, but he got some help. Chris Spire was saying home run right behind him.
I'm surprised we didn't get an argument from that Astros dugout. This ball was hooking the whole way down the left field line. The only question was fair or foul. It had plenty of distance, but C.B. Buckner, after a slight delay, gave the fair call and no argument. Because it hit the pole. That's why.
There you go. It'll be a tough play, and Ensberg couldn't field it cleanly. It's got to be an infield hit. For Merton, it is.
The way that light comes through the windows above the Crawford boxes, it was hard to track the flight of that ball. I just saw it land well into foul territory. I didn't realize that it had struck the foul pole. Ball was absolutely smoked. Hit about three quarters of the way up the foul pole.
Leadoff homer, infield single. Nafee one for one. He was thrown out at the plate in the third inning. And the Greg Maddux ground ball to short. Fouled back by Nafee. I want to thank everyone from every office with the Chicago Cubs. Andy McPhail, Mark McGuire, Jim Hendry, Mike Lafrano, their great staff, so Mary Fleeta, John Stockstill, Scott Nelson. Thanks to Chuck Wasserstrom, slicing foul out of play. Frank Maloney, Gary Hughes, I want to thank Gary, special assistant. See him on the road quite a bit. Paul Rathke, Mike Hill, all the ushers and security staff at Wrigley. Roger Baird, the head groundskeeper, and his great crew. Jody Reichel, Jennifer Surma, Carl Rice. I want to thank the Hall of Famers, Billy Williams, Ernie Banks, Ryan Sandberg, Ron Sano, who should be in the Hall of Fame. I want to thank Gary Pressey, Wayne Mesmer, Paul Friedman, Mike Terson, Doc Adams. Get me back to full health. I lost my voice. Jimmy Farrell, who we talked to the other day, Robert Chamberlain, Andy Akins upstairs in the press box. That is also foul. Dusty Baker certainly is coaching and strength and training staff, the medical staff, Cubs players. John McDonough, Jay Blunk, and their great marketing staff. Special kudos to Joe Rios, a.k.a. Mr. Chicago, Jim Obojkovic, Elizabeth Balthrop, and that entire crew. And a special thanks to Veronica Lopez as well. She just kind of takes care of everything, and we really appreciate it. Bouncer through the hole. Merton will take a look. He's on his way to third. He'll get there. First and third, no outs. Maddux coming up. Cubs rallying here in the fifth.
Maybe turnabout is fair play against Roy Oswalt. Oswalt drove in a run with a little ground ball through the left side. This time Nafee hits a 99 hopper through the right side, advancing Merton all the way around to third base. And Greg Maddux more than likely will be asked to put down a sacrifice bunt here to get Nafee into scoring position as well for the top of the order.
Three straight hits, a home run and two singles. Jim Hickey chatting with Roy Oswalt, and right now it sounds like it did at the start of yesterday's game. It's eerily quiet.
Pre-shock. They're not quite in shock yet, but they're waiting to go into shock. And then don't think for a moment they haven't noticed that out-of-town scoreboard and the fact that the Nationals have put up a three spot and made that game interesting.
Nafee Hendricks already ready to lay down a bunt. Right in the front of the batter's box. There's the bunt. Nafee on his way to second, but he is thrown out. That is a double play. I mean, you can't turn it any more perfectly than the Astros did. And of course, Merton held at third, so two outs.
Yeah, a rare bad bunt by Greg Maddux. Just bunts it too hard back to the mound. His counterpart, Roy Oswalt, a very athletic pitcher, bounces out off the mound, gets to the ball quickly, and once they get that lead runner at second base, it's going to be an easy double play.
Patterson slices one to the left. This one's going to get down. And the Cubs with another run. Patterson with a standing double. Big two-out hit. It's 3-2. Been a rough year for Corey, but he has reached twice today. Back in the leadoff spot. Hit by a pitch in the third inning. And an RBI double here in the fifth.
It's hard to fault Greg Maddux because he's done it so well for so long, but if he was able to get down a successful sack bunt, this game's tied up right now. Big at bat for Corey Patterson, fighting that pitch off to the opposite field, pulling the Cubs to within a run. He's in scoring position himself now for Jose Macias.
Matt Merton with the infield hit and scoring the run. Thank Cubs media relations staff, Sharon Panazzo, Samantha Newby, B.R. Kahneman, Teddy, Megan, and Charlie, the interns. Bounce strike to Adam Everett. Good inning for the Cubs, though. They get two and now trail by just a run. '06, which features 12 compelling portraits of the ballpark captured by team photographer Stephen Green. Fans could purchase a calendar for $14.95 plus shipping and handling by calling 1-800-248-9467. 3-2, the Cubs got a couple in the top of the fifth. Michael Barrett tying his career high with 16 home runs. Talking to him before the game, he said it's been a tough year. Cubs cannot finish at 500. Been a tough year for Corey Patterson, but a big RBI double closing the gap to one. And two quick ones on Willie Tavares. This is that shutdown inning we talked often about. Your team gets some runs, you want your starter to go right back out and shut down the other team's offense. Just missed. Ensberg and then Berkman. This backhanded play, Lee from his knees, safe. Maddux got over there, but Tavares, one of the fastest guys in the league. Infield hit for Willie Tavares. That is his 70th infield hit of the year.
Well, as always, Maddux, Derek Lee do everything in their power to get that out at first base, but just too much speed from Tavares. Very close play over there with the head first slide, but it did look like Tavares got the hand on the bag before Maddux got the foot on the bag. I don't expect Willie Tavares to be on first base very long. We've talked about it all season. We've talked about it his whole career. Teams try to run on Greg Maddux whenever possible. Certainly Willie Tavares is a guy that will run on anybody.
Speed is his game. Not running. Strike one, 1-1. Long pause by Maddux. Not running this time.
That's one thing Mad Dog can do to try to slow Tavares down over there at first base is break up his rhythm to home plate. Quick pitch one, hold the ball the next time. Couple throws over to first, step off the rubber. Just don't fall into a rhythm where Tavares could time the delivery and get a big jump.
And Hill are up for the Cubs. Swing and a miss. One out here in the fifth. That is Maddux's first strikeout today. 3,051 in his career.
Maddux's head is always in the ball game. As soon as that ball was swung on and missed, his neck immediately whipped around to see if Tavares was still at first base or if he was running on the pitch. But Tavares still anchored over there at first base.
Outside corner. And off the end of the bat. So it's 1-2 on Lance Berkman. And Lamb on deck. He has two hits. Has knocked in one and scored one. And not too long ago looked pretty good for the Astros. They led by three. And now it's down to just a one run lead. Phillies game getting tighter. 5-3. After six. And as you pointed out, Ryan Church with a 3-run homer to put the Nationals on the board. Berkman swings and misses, and Maddux with his first two strikeouts coming here in the fifth inning.
Well, once again, watch Maddux's head after the ball is swung on and missed. He whips around to see where Tavares is. I'm shocked Tavares is still at first base. I really am. I know this is the middle of the Astros order. They're run producers, and you don't want to run into outs on the bases, but with Tavares' speed, Maddux's slow delivery to the plate, this is pretty close to a sure thing should he attempt to run.
Ball, no strikes on Lamb. Tavares still not moving. Macias will throw to Lee. That ends the inning. Tavares led off the frame with an infield hit, but he never got to second.
The following takes place between 8 and 10 Eastern Sunday night.
Who are you working for?
Jack Bauer doesn't get second chances.
Shoot me or help me, but decide now.
You do. Relive the riveting first season. 24 every weekend.
Beginning tonight at 8 Eastern.
Ding.
You are now free to enjoy your flight.
And how little you paid for it.
Ding.
You're now free to have a frequent flyer program you can actually use.
Ding.
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 You are now free.
Free to find a low fare anytime you need one.
Free to sit in any seat in the cabin.
Ding.
Ding.
You're now free to fly nonstop to
Orlando.
Philly.
Las Vegas.
You are now free to enjoy flying again.
We've nearly doubled our service out of Midway in the past 2 years. So now it's even easier for you to get out of town.
You are now free to move about the country.
It was my first team.
It was my first time under pressure.
My first feeling of pride.
It was my first big break.
My first moment to shine.
My first shot at success.
It was my first job.
My first job.
It was my first job.
But what I learned there
will last forever.
Please join McDonald's in thanking the restaurant crew and managers who serve you every day.
This is our marathon station. We own it, we run it, and you know, we're proud to be part of this community.
My name's on the door, so everything's gotta be right. I mean, these people know me, and I wanna take care of them.
When you're an independent dealer, your reputation's on the line every day.
But it's not just about running a business for us. It's about being a part of a community that we care about.
We know what our customers want because we know our customers.
Helping friends and neighbors, that's the spirit of America. Marathon, fueling the American spirit.
Hall of Famers Sandberg, Williams, Banks, and many more current and former Cubs will be at the 21st Annual Cubs Convention January 13th through the 15th. Reserve your room at the Hilton Chicago for the weekend by calling 312-922-4400. Weekend passes are $50. They'll go on sale Monday, November 7th at 10 a.m. For more information, Cubs.com or 773-404-CUBS. Rough start to Derek Lee's afternoon. He's 0 for 2 with two strikeouts. Greg Maddux giving up a leadoff hit in the fifth, but no runs.
Well, seeing Taveras stay at first base that entire sequence makes you think there might be something wrong with him. This is a guy that normally runs every opportunity he gets, and that certainly appeared to be a golden opportunity for the Astros center fielder, but never moved off of first base.
Slow grounder, Biggio to Lamb, and Lee is 0 for 3. But Pujols 0 for 2 at 329. Derek still one extra base hit away from 100 and one hit away from 200. Nomar knows what it's like to win batting titles. He has a couple of them after the Red Sox in the American League. Speaking of the Red Sox, they have added a run and lead the Yankees 2-0 in the bottom of the fourth inning. Bill Miller with his 10th home run. Jared Wright against Curt Schilling. Scott Proctor is now on for the Yankees. Right with 3 1/3. Nomar to right. Lane coming on. And it's a base hit. Nomar with a 9-game hitting streak to end the season.
Nomar, as usual, in a battle mode. And from the time he steps into that batter's box, he's ready to swing at every pitch. You can see the radar gun in the background, a 94-mile-an-hour fastball. He just fought it off into shallow right field.
Burnett has struck out twice. Big, slow curveball for a strike. There aren't too many guys who had that great a curveball, that slow a curve with a fastball that reaches the mid-90s. I think Eric Gagne is a guy you think about a little bit. Yeah, another flare, and it drops for Burnett. Back-to-back hits. I don't know if Jeremy even knew where that ball was. Yeah, he's pointing. I think he thought that ball was out of play. He did not really run out of the box. He had trouble locating where it was.
You can see he doesn't see where it is at all, much like the problems we had with Michael Barrett's home run with those big glass panel windows out there from center field all the way over into foul territory and left. Balls that go up in the air, you kind of lose them in the glare out there. It's tough to see where they go, even for the hitters.
Seven hits now for the Cubs. Barrett with a home run today.
Stay angry, Michael. Do it again.
Barrett says the key to this season is understanding why this team struggled and trying to learn from it and get better next year. Boy, hit that ball hard in the ground. We'll see if Nomar is going to try to score. He will. Here comes a throw to the plate way up the line, and it allows him to score. A good throw likely gets him at the plate. It is 3-3. Barrett with a home run and an RBI single today.
Michael Barrett hits this ball as hard as his home run on a line through the right side. However, that was a fastball up and away. Very aggressive send by Chris Spier. Lane got to that ball in pretty good shape, but his throw was way up the line at third, giving Nomar an avenue around Brad Ausmus to the plate.
The Cubs have really bunched their hits together against Oswald. Merton to center, but Tavares will lay out and make the catch. Burnett's able to get back to second. The Cubs were looking for yet another bloop hit, but Tavares with a nice catch out in right center.
Boy, speed makes up for a lot of bad jumps out there in the outfield, and understandably, Tavares was fooled. That ball was just a little floater hit into shallow center. He got a late jump, but that tremendous speed made up for the bad break.
Nafe lines to right. Burnett's around third. Here's the throw by Lane. Cubs lead. Nafe battling through a painful left wrist is 3-for-3. And the Cubs now have their first lead of the afternoon.
Nafe stays on that slow curveball, tracks it well, just flips it out there into shallow right field, actually medium depth right field. The fact that Lane was moving to his left didn't allow him to get much on that throw to the plate. Burnie scores easily. Jim Hickey out to the mound now to have a talk with his starter. This has to be tempting right here for Dusty Baker to hook Greg Maddux for a pinch hitter. You've given Greg Maddux a lead. He's a pitcher of record. He would stand to win this ball game if the Cubs could make the lead stand up and an opportunity to possibly tack on another insurance run. But Maddux is going to take the at bat here. Two outs. Jeremy Burnett's running on contact. Good turn right there at third base. And the hard slide into home, not necessary, but it looked good.
Two in the fifth, two more here in the sixth, and the Cubs have erased a 3-0 deficit, now lead by a run.
Well, the biggest concern for the Cubs right now is always team first. You want to win this ball game, but a close second is getting Maddux a victory in this game. Assuming he's going to make the third out of the inning here and go back out to start the bottom half of the sixth, if a runner gets on base against him and ends up scoring, he'll get a no decision in this ball game.
Rainbow to right, Lane makes a catch. Two runs on four hits. Barrett and Perez with the RBI knocks 4-3.
The following takes place between 8 and 10 Eastern Sunday night.
Who are you working for?
24.
Beginning tonight at 8 Eastern.
Hey! Self-defense. First rule is 90% instinct. Like when I try to do this. Good. She covered. Now, what if I try to take your Bud Light?
Bud Light. Great taste for your great times.
What's mine is mine.
Jim's best friend died of a heart attack with no warning, and I worried it could happen to Jim. His doctor said you should always have Genuine Bear at hand. Just one has enough aspirin to help save your life during a heart attack.
We both feel better when I have my Bear.
Right now, you can get up to $500 off select John Deere riding lawn tractors. Plus, no interest and no payments until April 2006. But hurry into your nearest John Deere dealer because this window of opportunity will soon be closed.
Action tailgate and an industry first lockable in-bed trunk. The Ridgeline from Honda.
Hey, that looked like my fish.
Race car driver, it's a reality at 200 miles per hour.
And you're riding shotgun.
A Superstation WGN original race car driver. Wednesday night at 8 Eastern.
Time to check in on our Honda Ridgeline game summary. Corey Patterson with an RBI double. Nathy Perez 3-for-3. Patterson leading off. Perez hitting 8, in part because Nathy's left wrist has been bothering him. Biggio 2-for-3. Lamb the same for the Astros. And thanks to Honda for sponsoring the game summary this year. Well, Nathy can nurse that wrist for the next 5 months. And he wanted to be in there today. Michael Barrett with a home run and an RBI single. Greg Maddux here in the sixth inning. One ball, no strikes on Jason Lane. Nomar with a single to start that rally in the top of the inning. High in the air, deep to left, and it is tied. Long no-doubter for Jason Lane, and what you feared has come to fruition on the second pitch of the sixth. 4-4.
Ball was kind of tailing more than sinking, just came right back into the head of Jason Lane's bat, and you're right, there was no doubt about that one.
Not even sure where it landed, to be honest, because again, we got the sun coming in through the panels. But the pitcher, the hitter, and everybody else in the park knew exactly where it was, and that was over the fence. Maddux has now allowed 29 home runs, second most he's allowed in a single season. Wirtz and Hill throwing once again. A 4-4 tie. Just missed again. Maddux really wanted it.
Well, I think you saw a little indication back there from Phil Cuzzi, the home plate umpire. He kind of pointed at himself. He started up as if he were going to call a strike and then stopped. And then right at the very end, he kind of put his hand on his chest to indicate that I missed that one.
Omar's had a busy day.
Still a very manageable pitch count for Greg Maddux. Well, you never know what would happen if things were different. We talked about Maddux coming out of the ballgame for a pinch hitter, so he would be the pitcher of record with a lead in the sixth inning of a ballgame. You don't know what happens when the reliever comes into the ballgame. He may give up a leadoff home run, but certainly now, you almost feel like you got to keep riding Greg Maddux to leave him in there, give his chance a team to get back into this ballgame, take another lead.
Everett with a one out single. Roy Oswalt walking back into the Astros dugout.
Oswalt looking for his 20th victory of the season today. Will be hooked in a tie game.
Of course, if the Astros get the lead here in the sixth, he has a shot at his 20th. Jeff Bagwell, a thunderous ovation.
Bagwell, a 309 lifetime hitter against the future Hall of Famer Greg Maddux with 7 home runs. He has struck out 15 times, however. Long history between these two. This will be the 82nd at bat for Jeff Bagwell against Greg Maddux.
Bill Garner has to pick the right spot to use Bagwell because he can't play defense. He decides it. This is the time today. One out of the sixth with a man out. Well, we said it the other day. It's strange to see Bagwell in the box and Biggio on deck. Usually it's the other way around. It's almost as if there's an imaginary stool in the batter's box. Jeff Bagwell looks like he is sitting down in his stance.
It's one of the more uncomfortable looking setups in all of baseball, probably along with Moises Alou, who has that exaggerated knock-kneed stance. And we tried to tell our pitchers and catchers to hold the ball as long as you can. Keep him in that position as long as you possibly can before you deliver a pitch. Eventually, quads will start quivering and they'll have to call timeout and step out of the box.
I would say it has worked just fine for Jeff Bagwell. 449 career home runs. He has reached out, poked one foul to stay alive. He probably knows what it's like to be a catcher because of that stance. Can't be very good for your knees. You have to have a pretty strong trunk to hold yourself up.
Of course, as a starter, he only has to do it four or five times
That's
a game.
True.
Whereas the catcher's back there for 150 pitches.
Well said. I knew I couldn't get that one past you.
No. Nice try.
Well, he knows what it's like to catch four pitches.
There you go. We'll give you that one.
Everett is the runner at first with one out. Nafee will get it to second. Would have been late anyway, I think. And this is going to be all kinds of trouble. Everett will be able to score. Bagwell on his way to third. I don't think Nafee really had a play at second base. And the throw got past Macias. And the Astros now lead.
Nafee's made so many great defensive plays already in this series, but I agree with you on that one. I think the right play was to charge that ball, go across the infield, get the sure out at first base. A pretty good runner in Adam Effort going into second base right there.
So a pinch runner will be used for Bagwell. It'll be Charles Gibson, who's trying to become this year's version of Dave Roberts, a pinch running specialist. And that's it for Greg Maddux. Cubs got the lead 4-3, but two runs in the bottom of the inning, and the Astros back on top 5-4. Michael Wirtz coming in. He'll be back.
Such thing as
no,
oh, come on. Someone drank my Sierra Mist again.
What is it you were telling me you go on vacation again every year?
Honolulu.
Glenn, what'd you have for lunch today?
I had garlic pizza.
Keisha, I really like your new glasses. Are they good?
Yes.
Okay. I distinctly detect the citrusy lemon lime aroma of Sierra Mist on your breath.
Are you sure?
Smell her.
Yep.
Action tailgate and an industry first lockable in-bed trunk. The Ridgeline from Honda.
Hey, that looked like my fish.
Dell has great deals on PCs waiting for you now. Get this Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 4 processor for only $599. Plus, get a free flat panel upgrade. Other Dell desktops start at $349. Get more out of now. Dell PCs use Intel Pentium 4 processors.
Time now for our Budweiser Game Time Fan Camp from Houston. I Hope is the selection. Today's theme song, certainly for Astros fans.
Thank you.
new recording by the Dixie Chicks to benefit the victims of Hurricane Katrina. A lot of hoping around here today. The Astros now have the lead once again, 5-4. Greg Maddux cannot get a win now, so he will finish under 500 for the first time since he went 6-14 with the Cubs in 1987. And again, the best he can hope for is a no decision. Infield in. Ball one on Craig Biggio. Michael Wirtz with his third appearance in this series. Seventy-fifth appearance for Wirtz on the season. So just out of the top 10 in appearances in the National League. An error by Nathy Perez allowing the Astros to get their fifth run. Gibson, the pinch runner, is at third. Kicks away. Gibson in. Six to four. That run charged to Maddux.
The fastball in the dirt that time from Michael Wirtz. Talked about this repeatedly throughout the season. As a catcher, you always anticipate a breaking ball or a changeup going in the dirt. You rarely anticipate a fastball going into the dirt. That time Michael just couldn't get himself into a good position to block it quickly enough.
Everybody back with nobody on. It's been a roller coaster ride here today. The Astros led 3-0. Cubs jumped up 4-3. The Astros are 3 here in the sixth, and they now lead 6-4. Bounce toward Nomar. Fair ball. They got him. So Nomar with one of his better plays at third base. Hey, don't forget, Alter Bridge, the group with the music-making portion of Creed, will be performing at the House of Blues Chicago on October 25th as part of the Bud Light True Music Series. Bud Light True Music, great taste for your great times. And thanks to everyone at Anheuser-Busch for all their help and sponsorship. Willie Tavares with 2 outs. Lee will scamper over and get the first before Tavares. 3 runs in the sixth inning. Oswalt does have a shot at his 20th win. He's out into the Astros bullpen in the seventh inning.
Chicago Cubs baseball is brought to you by Pepsi, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball and the Chicago Cubs.
So you didn't win an Xbox 360 system in the Mountain Dew sweepstakes?
I won the Xbox 360! This is the best day of my life!
But remember, in 10 minutes, there's going to be a doozy of a multicolored archway in the sky. Because there's another chance to win every 10 minutes for 9 weeks.
I'm a winner. Maybe.
So grab another Dew and enter at every10minutes.com.
Next up is number 3. Your word is flossy nossy nihilipilification.
F-L-X-C-K-I.
No hard words.
Can you give it to me in a sentence, please?
That's why Geico.com is so simple. Or is it because you can file a claim, make changes, or pay your bill online? 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. Simple as that.
It was my first team.
It was my first time under pressure.
My first feeling of pride.
It was my first big break.
My first moment to shine.
My first shot at success.
It was my first job.
My first job.
It was my first job.
But what I learned there
will last forever.
Please join McDonald's in thanking the restaurant crew and managers who serve you every day.
This game's been all over the place today. Right now it's 6-4 Astros as we move to the seventh inning. And unfortunately for Greg Maddux, he will be unable to get his 14th win, and he'll finish the year under 500.
You know, I don't think Mad Dog was as concerned with it as we were up here, as his teammates were. But it's just unfortunate the way that thing slipped away right there. We talked about it at the time. Possibly could have been handled a little differently, but you never know what would transpire if you did handle it differently. So I'm sure Greg Maddux is not going to point any fingers or blame anybody. He didn't pitch well today. He'd be the first to admit it. Gave up 10 base hits in 5 1/3 innings. But the Cubs have shown great resilience in this final series of the year here in Houston. Their ability to come back in the first couple of games of this series. So see what happens here against Chad Qualls.
And Roy Oswalt does have a chance for his 20th win. Let's pause for station identification.
This is America's home for sports all year round. Superstation WGN.
Bob Brenly, Len Casper, and our WGN Sports crew, Pete Toma, Skip Ellison, Mark Brady, here in Houston for a final telecast in game 162 for the Cubs. Patterson strikes out to start the seventh. This is game 163 for the Astros, who had a tie earlier in the year. June 30th at Cincinnati in a game that was stopped because of rain at 2-2 in the seventh. The line on Greg Maddux, 5 1/3, 10 hits, 6 runs, 4 were earned. A walk, 2 Ks, a home run, and his earned run average 4.24. Which will be the highest ERA he has had in a season since 1987. And it was at 5.61. Lamb will tag out Macias. Let's get this 200 hit thing out of the way right here. Derek Lee 0-for-3. His last hit was a single in the fourth inning Friday night. 0-for-6 since. His foot, Pujols 0-for-3. For the Cardinals first baseman hitting 329, Derek at 336.
Good history here, very abbreviated history. Derek Lee 5 at bats against Chad Qualls. He's got 3 singles.
Right center field, and it will be caught. Lane and Tavares were looking at each other, wondering who was going to catch it. Lee is 0-for-4. We're going to keep it here, middle of the seventh. For God Bless America, it is 6-4 Astros.
It's our Sunday afternoon tradition here at Minute Maid Park. At this time, we kindly ask that you please rise and join us for the singing of God Bless America.
Thank you.
The following takes place between 8 and 10 Eastern Sunday night.
Who are you working for?
Jack Bauer doesn't get second chances.
Shoot me or help me, but decide now.
You do. Relive the riveting first season. 24 every weekend.
Beginning tonight at 8 Eastern.
Do you have a dinosaur?
No.
Do you have a mummy?
No.
Do you have the space shuttle?
No.
What do you have?
Well, we have a display of the local gopher in its natural habitat.
That's not a gopher.
Yeah, it is.
Take them to a place that has it all. Fly Southwest Airlines from Chicago Midway to BWI Airport for just $89 one way.
You are now free to move about the country.
Farmer's Health Point, how can I help you?
Hi, this is not just got rear-ended by some yahoo.
Are you okay?
Well, I'm fine. My car is a little busted up, though.
No problem. We'll take care of it.
How fast can Farmer's Health Point service get your car fixed after an accident? Well, you get the idea. Help Point is free with your policy. To find an agent near you, call 1-800-FARMERS.
Action tailgate and an industry first lockable in-bed trunk. The Ridgeline from Honda.
Hey, that looked like my fish.
6-4 Astros, bottom of the seventh inning. Will Omen is on. 42,288, the 16th sellout of the year for the Astros, and the biggest crowd of this weekend set. The Astros are trying to clinch the National League wild card. The Red Sox have clinched the American League wild card. After the Indians lost, they were swept by the White Sox 3-1 the final in Cleveland today. So the White Sox will host the Red Sox Tuesday afternoon, just after 3 o'clock, in game one of the division series. That means the Yankees will match up with the Angels. The Indians lost their final three and 6 of 7, and the White Sox will go into the playoffs having won 5 in a row. They finished with 99 wins. I think the way it works out, if the Angels win and the Yankees lose, the Angels would have home field against New York. It's 6-4 Angels in Texas in the middle of the seventh. One and two on Morgan Ensberg. Slider, left center. Martin lays out, can't get it. Leadoff single for Ensberg, his second hit today. How many bloop hits have we seen for both teams today? I mean, ball's just eluding defenders in the outfield.
We've seen a bunch of them. I think that speaks to the quality of pitching that we had in this ball game. Neither Oswald nor Maddox on top of their game today, but kept the ball off the sweet spot of the bat for the most part. And when good pitchers do that, you see a lot of bloop hits.
Do we have parity in the major leagues? It seems like everybody's more bunched together than ever before. You have the strange situation in the National League. Could be 2-4-6-3 the easy way. Look, very routine for the Cubs. You have all the teams in the National League East that'll finish at least 500. The only team in the West over 500 is the Padres, but they're only a game over. They could finish at 500. There's no real elite mean, team that just jumps out at you. I mean, the Cardinals have been the best team in this league. They have not played their best baseball lately. I guess my point is nobody looks unbeatable.
I don't think there's a clear-cut favorite. I mean, you can make a strong argument for any of the teams headed for the postseason that they have the right combination to win, but I agree with you. I don't think there is a clear-cut favorite. I mean, this Astros ball club, as ineffective as they've been offensively throughout the year, with the pitching that they have at the top of that rotation, if they play sound defense, they could be very dangerous in the postseason. I think a lot of people are writing off Atlanta because they have so many young kids in the lineup that produced well during the regular season, but they're going to get their first taste of October baseball, and counting on rookies is a dangerous way to go about it in the postseason. They may step up to the plate and do their job, or they may fail miserably. Who knows?
Maybe the lack of failure in the postseason for a lot of those young guys, even though they are with Atlanta, but not a lot of those guys were with the Braves and they lost all those postseason series. Maybe that'll in a way help them. Ignorance is bliss.
I'm telling you, sometimes kids don't know any better. All they know is, hey, we got a game today.
I think the White Sox in the end will benefit from having to play all those huge games when back in early August looked like they were going to clinch before September. The Padres can be loose because nobody will pick them in the National League. Olman strikes out Lamb to end the seventh. We'll head to the eighth. Nomar will lead it off 6-4.
All right. Hey, you guys want a Bud Light?
Oh, yeah.
It's my new Bud Light bot. Check this out. It runs entirely on Bud Light. I gotta give me one of those.
Bud Light. Great taste for your great times.
Honey, the Bud Light bot's creeping me out again.
Right now, you can get up to $500 off select John Deere riding lawn tractors. Plus, no interest and no payments until April 2006. But hurry into your nearest John Deere dealer because this window of opportunity will soon be closed.
Steven!
Oh, I was just hungry.
Mother's dinner not good enough for you?
Sorry.
Oh, you're darn right you're sorry.
Everyone wants the new fresh toasted chicken parmesan sandwich, zesty marinara, melted cheese, only at Subway restaurants.
Choosing a new low-cost internet service? Check this out. With Netscape's new Web Accelerator, I can surf up to 5 times faster than standard dial-up. And with Netscape, I get Web Accelerator for just $9.95.
Net Zero charges $14.95 for that.
Same speed, less money.
Works for me.
Get Netscape with new Web Accelerator and surf up to 5 times faster for just $9.95. That's over 30% less than Net Zero.
It's just the net you need.
Da Vinci's Inquest, Tuesday night at 8 Eastern on Superstation WGN.
Some changes for the Astros defensively. Eric Bruntlett now playing left field, moving Lance Berkman to first. So Mike Lamb is out. And Dan Wheeler here in the eighth inning will do the pitching. Nomar, Burnitz, Barrett. Nomar started the 2-run rally in the sixth with a 1-out single.
Need an extended inning here in the eighth, obviously, hopefully to score some runs, get some guys on base, make some things happen, but also to ideally get that lineup to roll over and get Derek Lee one more at bat in this ball game in the ninth.
Popped up by Garcia Parra near second. Right in front of the bag is Everett. That's a first down. Here's Burnett's. Jeremy will have played at 160 games here in 2005. He appeared in 161 games twice with Milwaukee in 1998 and again in 2000. The 160 games leading the Cubs this year. Derek Lee right behind him at 158. Check swing foul behind the visiting dugout. Well, that's going to leave a mark. And looks like he's all right, but that really hurt. Hammered, but he pulled it too much. Nathy Perez, 154 games. Can't say enough about the job he's done. Well, he was not expected to play even 100 games. He was a super utility guy starting the season.
I think the theory going in was Nathy would get between 200 and 300 at bats as a part-time player, backing up all around the infield. But because of the injuries, was forced into regular duty and responded very well.
Ausmus makes a catch.
And Burnett's fooled on this pitch, gets way out in front, just kind of a defensive swing, but unfortunately pops it straight up to Brad Ausmus behind the dish.
So it's up to Michael Barrett here in the eighth inning. Only four outs to work with for the Cubs, and they're down two. Bounding ball, sending Everett in. And a quick eighth inning for Dan Wheeler. Cubs can expect to face Brad Lidge in the ninth, even if the Astros lead by 10, because they want to win to clinch the wild card.
The following takes place between 8 and 10 Eastern Sunday night.
Jack Bauer doesn't get second chances.
Shoot me or help me, but decide now.
You do. Relive the Rickey first season. 24 every weekend.
Beginning tonight at 8.
Hey, I'll take one of those chickens.
Sure. Which one?
Thousand hand slap.
I'm gonna go with that one.
Good choice.
I've been in this room before.
What?
I've been here before.
Yeah. You took the virtual tour at hotels.com?
Right.
Want to check out your hotel before you check in? Send in the experts at hotels.com. They check out thousands of hotels and bring you tools like virtual tours so you can look before you book. Log on or call now to find great deals everywhere. Hotels.com. We know hotels inside and out.
Go!
Jim's best friend died of a heart attack with no warning, and I worried it could happen to Jim. His doctor said you should always have Genuine Bear at hand. Just one has enough aspirin to help save your life during a heart attack.
We both feel better when I have my Bear.
Right now, you can get up to $500 off select John Deere riding lawn tractors, plus no interest and no payments until April 2006. But hurry into your nearest John Deere dealer, because this window of opportunity will soon be closed.
Time to have a ball with the Illinois Lottery. Boy, exciting atmosphere here in Houston. Astros trying to clinch the wild card, and that is extremely impressive. He's out like a light.
Wake me up when the playoffs start.
Thanks to our friends for their sponsorship of Have a Ball, the Illinois Lottery. Jermaine Van Buren has some family in town watching this weekend in Mississippi. And he'll work here in the eighth inning. We saw so much cotton candy this year. I don't think we got our hands on any of it.
Well, we'll let her handle the honor. She's doing a good job down there. Sticky fingers.
Judge Van Buren trying to keep the Astros right where they are. Give the Cubs a shot in the ninth. Some more thank yous to the Cubs organization, Lena McDonough, the publications department. We want to thank Ed Hardig, Cubs historian, who knows just about everything there is to know about the Cubs and their history dating back to 1876. So, Ed, thank you. All the great folks at Stats Inc. for providing great stats for us. Steve Bird and his crew. Special thanks to Jeff Cherno. I like to bug Jeff, late Saturday night. I'll send him an email saying, I'm looking for a note here, and he'll email right back. Tom Hellman, Gary Stark, Rich Rupp, Jonathan Veramis, the Cubs clubhouse, handling all the equipment and the luggage on the road. Michael Burkhart, Yosh Kuano, the visiting clubhouse at Wrigley, Ed Cohn and his staff in the Cubs video room. I want to thank Cubs traveling secretary Jimmy Bank, who has probably the toughest job in baseball. Bounced foul. I want to thank the fine folks at United, Cubs charter service. Marcia, Helen, Debbie, and Julie, who do a great job on the flights. Three and two. And Lane gets the walk. No swing.
It's hard to make much of a judgment on Jermaine Van Buren. We've seen so little of him since he was called up here to the major league level, but you saw his stats when he came into the game in 5 1/3 innings. He'd only surrendered 2 base hits. However, that was his 9th walk of the season. So it's pretty apparent what the Cubs would like to see improvement from with Jermaine Van Buren. Throw the ball over the plate. He's got good stuff.
Bunted by Ausmus, foul. Astros continue to try to just get every run they possibly can. Taveras with 2 sack bunts in the first 3 innings. There's the bunt. Lee charging. He will fire to second. He just got Jason Lane. Risky throw, but it paid off.
That was one of the more risky attempts by Derek Lee this year. Ball popped up in the air. That forced the runner to hold momentarily. Maybe that's why Derek thought he had enough time to go to second base. Very poor slide out there by Jason Lane. And the idea is to get to the bag as quickly as possible. He just now touched the bag with his right hand. He was going out of his way, it looked like, to try to knock Nathy Perez out of the play. He never really was on the base.
Well, that's a great point you made. He beat the throw with the slide, but he just never got to the base. He went after the defender instead.
You see that happen sometimes with a runner sliding into second base where his lead leg, his front leg, will go right over the top of the bag and he doesn't hit the base until the the bent leg on the slide hits the bag. And many times that's the difference in safe and out at second base.
One oh pitch in there for a strike. Pitcher Wheeler on deck. Brad Lidge getting ready for the ninth inning. That would be his biggest save opportunity of the year. Osmus running and pulled foul out of play. Roger Clemens wants to pitch in the postseason. Left hamstring was fine yesterday. He got the win. Down ball right to Macias and out at second. Safe at first. Another bang bang play in this series.
See more fielder's choices in this series than any series I could remember all year. Oh boy. You rarely see Derek argue a call over there at first base with that much animation. Derek Crawford, the crew chief, ball was just stumbled a little bit there by Macias, but that shouldn't really have affected the play at all. And I think the Astros got a break over there at first base.
Dusty Baker heading out. Orlando Palmeiro just announced as a pinch hitter. Rich Hill will come in with the left-handed hitter coming up. 6-4 Houston, bottom of the eighth, and we'll be right back.
Hey! Self-defense, first rule, is 90% instinct. Like when I try to do this. Good. She covered. Now, what if I try to take your Bud Light?
Great taste for your great times.
What's mine is mine.
Ah, that new destination smell. Introducing Southwest Airlines' new nonstop service to Fort Myers, Naples. Fly from Chicago Midway for just $79 one way.
You are now free to move about the country.
Hey, I'll take one of those chickens.
Sure. Which one? Thousand hand slap.
I'm gonna go with that one.
Good choice.
Hey, come on out. Got a big bowling tournament coming up to help strike out pediatric cancer. It's gonna be Saturday, November 12th. Carrie Wood and his wife Sarah will pitch in to help children with cancer by hosting a celebrity bowling tournament at 10 Pin Bowling Lounge. It's 330 North State to benefit Children's Memorial Hospital in Chicago. You can call the number on your screen or log on to carrystrikezone.com. Well, Rich Hill came back from the minor leagues on September 2nd. He didn't pitch until the 14th. A couple of days later, with two innings against St. Louis, And this is his first outing since September 16th. But he's been throwing on the side quite a bit. The first time in action since the middle of September. Facing Orlando Palmeiro, who throws to first, sending Adam Everett back. I wish a happy birthday to big Cub fan Mickey Dello. We're on October 2nd. Bunted toward third, foul.
Also want to send congratulations out to my niece Brian Triplett, who was married yesterday, to Bert Hutchinson in Lexington, Kentucky. Best wishes to them.
Everything's going all right?
Everything's going great so far.
It's good. Popped up by Palmeiro. Hill evacuating, and it's caught by Nomar. 6-4 as we head to the ninth.
Chicago Cubs baseball is brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Nonstop service to 59 destinations all across the country. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom.
We got you something. Southwest has new leather seats and roomier cabins for more comfortable flights.
I love leather.
You are now free to move about the country.
Dell has great deals on PCs waiting for you now. Get this Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 4 processor for only $599. Plus, get a free flat panel upgrade. Other Dell desktops start at $349. Get more out of now. Dell PCs use Intel Pentium 4 processors.
Steven!
I was just hungry.
Mother's dinner not good enough for you?
Sorry.
You're darn right you're sorry.
Everyone wants the new fresh toasted chicken parmesan sandwich, zesty marinara, melted cheese, only at Subway restaurants.
The following takes place between 8 and 10 Eastern Sunday night.
Who are you working for?
24.
Beginning tonight at 8 Eastern.
Brad Lidge. He is on, making his 70th appearance as he seeks his 42nd save. As the Astros try to clinch the wild card, Phillies in the ninth leading 9-3, bottom nine in Washington. But if the Astros win, it doesn't matter what the Phillies do. Chris Burke is playing left, and Bruntlett moves to second. Six to four Houston. Matt Merton, base hit to right. He's two out of four today. Well, they got a couple against Lidge Friday night. Merton started with a single that night. So Phillies can get to within a half game, but they need the Cubs to rally here in the ninth. Ben Grieve pinch hitting for Nathy Perez. Check swing strike. Todd Walker's on deck. He had the big hit two nights ago. Inside corner strike. Good block by Ausmus. Lidge is trying to save it for Roy Oswalt, who would get his 20th win. Greg Maddux, the pitcher of record for the Cubs. Greaves swings through, strike three.
That devastating slider. He uses it to righties and lefties. He'll throw it to both sides of the plate. Commands that power slider as well as most pitchers command their fastball.
Slider strike on Walker. He had a 3-0 pitch to right for the game-winning hit Friday night.
The Astros have been playing behind Matt Mertens over there at first base the entire inning after he reached on his base hit. General consensus is his run doesn't really mean anything, but if you can't score the fifth run, you can't score the sixth run. And if they're going to give him a bag, why not go ahead and take it? If it'd be different if Todd Walker had the hole on the right side of the infield and they were holding on Matt Mertens, then maybe you might leave him there and give Walker an area to hit to.
And Walker is extremely susceptible to a double play because he can't run.
So, you know, in my eyes, if they're going to give you the base, take the base. It stays out of the double play. You're guaranteed at least one more hitter coming to the plate.
Walker with a ground ball to the shortstop Everett. Dropped. There is an out. No save. The out call was made by Ed Rapuano, but then he changed his call. Bruntlett dropped it. First and second. Well, it got in the glove and then it got out. And the thing is, if he holds it cleanly, he probably turns the double play.
He never had possession of that ball at all. Bruntlett, a defensive replacement, played left field in the last inning, moves into second base for Craig Biggio, just never caught the ball. I mean, you're right, he's got all the time in the world. All he's got to do is catch the baseball and roll it over to first base to get Todd Walker at first, but couldn't hang on.
Ryan Terrio is a pinch runner at first, representing the tying run. Getting pretty interesting now. Strike one on Corey. There's the riot. Mertens in front of him at second. Macias on deck. Cue shot. Everett will throw to first this time. So second and third with two outs. A single could tie it. And it's up to Jose Macias. Derek Lee is on deck. He'll only bat if Jose can reach. All sorts of drama here in Houston. Lidge working from the windup. Strike one. Still two strikes. A final in D.C. The Phillies beat the Nationals 9-3. They probably all hurried back into the clubhouse to watch the end of this one. Cubs are down two, second and third. Two outs, two strikes. And Macias lines. It's caught by Bruntlett. The Cubs season comes to an end, and the Houston Astros are the wild card winners in the National League. So it'll be Houston and Atlanta in one division series, San Diego and St. Louis in the other. Roy Oswalt with his 20th win on the final day of the season. The Cubs threatened in the ninth and had two in scoring position with two outs. But Macias lined out to Eric Bruntlett, and that ended it. Well, what a series. They were all tight ball games. The Cubs won the first two. The Astros won the final two to clinch the wild card.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. A good series to watch. Unfortunately, it didn't mean as much for the Cubs as it did for the Astros, but Cubs came in here, battled hard these last four games of the season. Obviously, we're all disappointed that Derek Lee didn't get his one more extra base hit to get to 100 extra base hits and 200 hits on the season. We were looking forward to Jeremy Burnett's 300th homer and looking forward to Greg Maddux evening up his record at 500. But now we have something to look forward to next year.
So the Cubs end their season at 79-83. The Astros 89-73. And they have won the wild card two straight years. The Cubs watching second team clinch against them. The Cardinals did it in September, and the Astros here this afternoon. Brad Lidge blew the save Friday night, but he got the save yesterday and again today. It looks like Derek Lee is going to win the batting title in the National League. He did go 0-for-4 today. But his average at 335. Albert Pujols is 0-for-3. And as the Cardinals lead the Reds 6-5 in the seventh, he is at 329. And what a great year it was for Derek Lee. Unfortunately, Greg Maddux finishing the year two games under 500 at 13-15. Ryan Dempster, 33 out of 35 saves. Another big time bright spot for the Chicago Cubs. He's locked up through 2008, signed a 3-year deal yesterday. Matt Merton certainly made a name for himself. We'll talk about the positives and look ahead to 2006 when we come back. 6-4, the Astros win the wild card.
Premiere of 24 Weekends. Special Agent Jack Bauer uncovers a plot to kill a presidential candidate.
If Palmer gets hit, he'll tear this country apart.
But when Jack's own daughter is kidnapped, he's torn between family and duty.
You have no idea what you're getting yourself into.
On the premiere episode of 24 Weekend, tonight at 8 Eastern on Superstation WGN.
This place is disgusting. I feel dirty just being here.
All right. I've got one last thing I want you to see.
I think you're gonna like this.
Is that a...
Yes.
It's a beer tree.
Honey, we're home.
Bud Light. Great taste for your great times.
Nothing quite like a beer straight from the tree.
It was my first team.
It was my first time under pressure.
My first feeling of pride.
It was my first big break.
My first moment to shine.
My first shot at success.
It was my first job.
My first job.
It was my first job.
But what I learned there
will last forever.
Please join McDonald's in thanking the restaurant crew and managers who serve you every day.
Action tailgate and an industry first lockable in-bed trunk. The Ridgeline from Honda.
Hey, that looked like my fish.
They are celebrating here in Houston. The Astros have locked up the wild card in the National League. 6-4, the final over the Cubs. 11 hits for the Astros, 10 for the Cubs. 3 errors combined in this game. In fact, the Astros struggled defensively in this series. They committed 6 errors, but on the year were very good with the leather. Roy Oswalt with his 20th win. Greg Maddux finishes the year at 13-15. Brad Lidge with his 42nd save. And our final Budweiser play of the game for 2005. Off the bat, I think we all thought and hoped that that ball was going to get into right center. But Eric Grumlett over to make the catch.
Yeah, well, I thought that ball was headed for center field, and we were looking at possible extra innings, but unfortunately just wasn't hit hard enough to get through. And once Grumlett makes the play on that soft line drive, the celebration is on for the Astros.
So the Astros with 89 wins. That's good enough for the wild card. Cardinals and the Astros will represent the National League Central in the 2005 postseason. We'll have more to come from Minute Maid Park. Stay with us.
Destination smell. Introducing Southwest Airlines' new nonstop service to Fort Myers, Naples. Fly from Chicago Midway for just $79 one way.
You are now free to move about the country.
It takes a family to make a house a home, and a home to turn a dream into a future. So if you have a dream...
In Chicago, I'm your man. I'm an AmeriQuest mortgage specialist.
So if you're thinking of buying a home or refinancing...
I'll help you pay off your high-interest credit cards and lower your monthly payments.
I'm an AmeriQuest mortgage specialist, and I'm here to help you with your dream.
Call 1-800-AmeriQuest or visit AmeriQuest.com. AmeriQuest Mortgage, proud sponsor of the American Dream.
I can get so congested from my allergies that I feel like I'm not all there. But I've still got to report the story. So I found Claritin D and got Claritin Clear. That means I'm getting non-drowsy relief and doing my job.
Come on, you're on.
If you want long-lasting relief from your worst congestion, sinus pressure, and itchy eyes without getting drowsy, nothing is stronger or faster than Claritin D. It's the one that works for my allergies and my life. Non-drowsy Claritin D.
Live Claritin Clear.
Chicago Cubs baseball brought to you by Bud Light. Smooth and refreshing Bud Light. Great taste for your great times. The Illinois Lottery. No matter how you play, play the Illinois Lottery. Have a ball. Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns. Dodge. Pepsi, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball and the Chicago Cubs. CarQuest, 3,600 CarQuest auto parts stores across North America. And by Southwest Airlines, nonstop service to 59 destinations all across the country. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom.
Well, Larry Durker, now a broadcaster, former manager of the Houston Astros, on the field. The Astros have locked up the wild card with a 6-4 win over the Cubs on the final day of 2005.
Chicago
the Cubs
baseball.
Finished over 500 on the road. They went 41-40 on the road, 38-43 at Wrigley Field. But we just have a couple of minutes here to kind of recap the season and focusing on the positives. Ryan Dempster, Derek Lee, Carlos Zambrano, Matt Merton, Ronnie Cedeno, Rich Hill, some young guys we may see in the future, maybe next year.
Yeah, there were a lot of bright spots. Unfortunately, they were overshadowed by a lot of the dark spots that we saw this year as well. I think that there is a plan in place. I think Dusty and his staff know what they need to do come next spring to make this team more competitive on the field, be better fundamentally, and hopefully they'll be able to accomplish those things in spring training, and the beginning of the season next year will be much different than the beginning of the season this year.
Well, partner, I can't thank you enough, and you just made it so easy for me from day one. I feel like I've known you forever, and I can't wait till spring training of 06.
My sentiments exactly. Looking forward to it, partner.
You're the best, and thank you to the fans who made us feel very welcome from day one as well. So for Bob Brenly, Pete Toma, Skip Ellison, Mark Brady, Bob Vorwald, our great crews, thanks to Kelly and Jenny Adon here in the booth in Houston, our great crew here in Houston, Texas. The final score today, the Astros 6 and the Cubs 4. Joe Pizzo, also our studio coordinator back at WGN. We'll have baseball coming up in March of 2006. We'll see you then. Have a great winter. So long, everybody.